sex app. This is the Opie and Anthony Show.
Greatest laugh ever.
Fucking wizard.
He's
nice.
Still laughing in the background.
Alex from Ice Road Truckers. God, was he great. God, thank you, Roland. I got to thank Roland. Because we're not going to lie. We don't really know the show that well. And seen a little bit of it.
Yeah, I started watching a little
bit. Roland's like, no, trust me. You got to have this guy in. He's great. And you know what? That's why we have Roland around.
Because he's crazy. That
guy's
insane.
Think that guy's crazy?
Yeah, it's the whole
I think he's crazy. I think he's just naive as far as how the rest of the world is.
But it's,
he knows what he knows, and he knows it very well.
He has his place where he lives. You're only as crazy as where you come from, I guess.
Yeah.
And, you know, if you go from one place to another, you could be completely insane, but you're fine where you're from.
And you did notice that I hid my yogurt.
I know.
That is spelled F-A-G. Yeah. And then there is an E, but who cares about the E after... the word starts with F-A-G. That's my yogurt.
He came in. He's just holding his eggs and potatoes, and he's shoveling his mouth.
Just
talking. And Opie's got his yogurt and granola, and Jimmy's got his little faggot food.
No, I just start sliding mine away.
I couldn't have felt worse if I was eating out of a pair of balls.
That's a real man. If you think you're a man... It's guys like that that make you realize,
No, you're not.
I almost broke down and cried because I had to change my tire when it was like 20 degrees out.
I know,
He's talking about, well, you know, 40 below, 100 below.
Wind blowing. They're on this ice
fucking
road.
I'm defrosting my brakes so I can survive.
He's with a torch underneath his truck trying to defrost a brake. It's like,
I got a flat. Hello?
Here's me.
Hello, Mr. Kumia, OnStar. Can we help you?
I got a flat tire.
We'll send somebody immediately.
Please hurry. I'm in the middle of nowhere. I think it's Hopog. Can you please tell me if there's a Starbucks nearby?
Yeah.
I can wait.
Yes, there's one half a block away. You could probably walk there.
Walk! He's dealing with grizzly bears.
Yeah, bears and ice and fucking... He could fall into a river or off a ravine.
Tell us how... He basically said how great it is to breathe in minus 40 degree weather.
Yeah, to him, that's refreshing.
Refreshing.
Exactly. Where it's so cold, you could hear the northern lights crackling.
He did say that, right?
That's fucking cold. That is cold.
Cold is it?
I'm glad I wasn't in here for this. I don't need to feel less like a man
less
than I already
like a
do.
Man.
Yeah, this would have put me over the edge.
Yeah, you need shoulders to interview the guy. I'm sorry, Joe.
I had said I felt like
the Ice Road Trucker.
We felt like such fags just sitting here in front of like a real man. And Jimmy, we feel like fags sitting in front of the out queue guys.
We're just faggots.
We're just
I think those two guys are more manly than us.
Dude,
the ones that do the morning show.
I ride the elevator up. There's a black guy and a white guy. I ride the elevator up almost every morning with the black guy. They're nice guys.
Yeah.
Jim,
yeah.
That was called contributing nothing to the conversation. Gives a shit. I should have thought that. All kidding aside. Really, Jim?
All kidding aside, you know.
Somebody wants a montage of all the great laughs over the years from this radio show.
That's true.
Alex could have had the greatest laugh ever right there.
Yeah.
The one where he just kept going and going and going. It was psychotic. Me and Danny looked at each other like, this guy's out of his mind.
Maybe if there was a mic in the boss's office a month ago, he could have.
Oh, really? You had to do that to me today, right?
Hey, see,
I finally am over that bullshit.
No, that to me is like in a joking context for what we're doing. So, you know, they don't understand that.
Yeah, let's hear the laugh again. Get me back up.
That's the last thing a hooker hears before her life just slowly seeps away from being strangled in the back of his cab.
Yeah, the sound in an altar boy's ear.
Oh, God. Just remembers it forever.
She hears that laugh and then she wonders, what is that sound of something cutting through the air, not realizing that it's a hoe headed for the back of her head, swinging a garden implement?
I wanted to talk to the guy about how long like their summer is. When does it start snowing?
He just wanted to talk about whatever the fuck he wanted to talk about.
How many? I mean, how many days of summer do you think they get? A week or two, maybe. A couple weeks.
Got to be nothing.
5 weeks, maybe.
Nothing. It's always dark. It's always just dark there.
That I want to know about.
It's expensive too. Did you ever go up to Alaska?
No.
They're in Alaska, right?
Well, they're kind of in the Canadian part next to Alaska.
I did a show in Alaska. I did some shit club up there, and it was really fucking expensive because you forget they got
to
import everything.
Everything has to
into
come
the fucking
from there,
state.
Yeah.
And it looks like you're in shithole South Jersey or something, and you're paying like $14 for a fucking cheeseburger. You're like, this place sucks.
It didn't match up, right?
This is
in Venice. It's fucking...
That's the same thing with Hawaii, but it's fucking Hawaii.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, I'm in Hawaii.
At least
this
you know
is beautiful.
It's Hawaii.
Yeah.
All right, why don't we move on?
Alaska.
Couple things. Can we do the Larry King really fast, and then we're gonna move into Jocktober.
Yeah, I
want to
hear what did he do. He had a senile moment.
I have not seen this yet, but people are saying it could be his greatest fuck up yet.
Ah,
it's too bad he's going away. What at the end of the year? He's
only got a month or two left. December 18th, I think, is his last day.
So less than 2 months. We say goodbye to Larry King.
Ah, there he is with Jesse Ventura.
How old is he now?
He's about 62.
That's it?
No way.
Jesus Christ.
Jesus to you. What the fuck?
He's got to be pushing 80
Gary
at least.
Gary Gullible.
He's not already 80. Gary Gullible.
I don't fucking know. I don't watch him. Watch that old douche.
Is this it?
Larry.
Once it loads, it will be.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, the old load.
Why,
Computers are the worst here. Oh, here we go. Got to pot it up.
Jillian, shortly before the massive release
Sounds
of the
drunk.
Iraqi war documents, you walked out of an interview by CNN's Atika Schubert. She asked you about any turmoil within WikiLeaks and about accusations of rape and molestation by two Swedish women. He's walking off again, apparently. Why will you not respond to that question? Daniel, are you still there?
Yeah, sure.
I guess you can't answer for him. Oh, that was the video from before. You still.
Oh, wow.
Why did you walk off?
Jesus.
Well, I didn't walk off, Larry, just then, but perhaps I.
All right, obviously, the obvious. That audio's not slowed down?
No.
Then he's on some. He was on a pill or something.
Did you hear the way he was slurring? He's like. And then they went to the video clip because Larry's talking about the guy walking off of this woman's interview. So they switched to the video clip. Now, what Larry's looking at is a big screen in front of him because this guy isn't in Larry's studio. He's on a remote location. So Larry's looking at the screen. They switched to the replay of when he did walk off that woman's show. You see the woman sitting there, the interviewer.
Jesus
and you
Christ.
See him in a totally different outfit.
Yeah.
And he's getting up, taking his equipment off, his mic off. And Larry's just like... Oh, he's walking off again. Why won't you respond to this?
In Larry's defense, it's hard to concentrate on the here and now when you're shitting your pants.
Yeah.
You know.
Oh, my God. It was how many years ago? 75 years ago, the Hindenburg exploded. Oh, my God, a dirigible's blowing up in Lakers, New Jersey as we speak. Oh, look at my God, I guess it injured the camera because it's in black and white. We're going to try to get the color feed to you.
You got to update your impression, though. We got an under the influence Larry King in my humble
He sounded
opinion.
Fucked
Let's
up.
Let's hear that again, man. Listen to
Listen, this. Right when he starts, he sounds fucked up.
And I thought the audio was fucked up.
Julian, shortly before the massive release of the Iraqi war documents, you walked out of an interview by CNN's Atika Schubert.
Atika Schubert.
Turmoil within WikiLeaks and about accusations of rape and molestation.
Look, sounds like Liza Minnelli.
He's walking off again, apparently.
No!
Why would you not respond to that question? Daniel, are you still there?
Yeah, sure.
I guess you can answer for him.
Look at the guy looks over like, wait a minute, he's here.
I'm sorry, that threw me, Julian.
I haven't walked off.
Why did you walk off?
Oh, my God.
Ladies and gentlemen, terrible news.
Wow.
President Kennedy has been shot. I've seen it with my own eyes. Oh, my God. They're driving away at a high rate of speed. I hope the president is okay.
This is terrible. The second tower is falling.
It's falling down. I believe this could be terrorist related.
You're missing the obvious. Yes. Frankie Blue.
Frankie Blue. Drunk off his
One
ass.
One of our favorites of all time. Wow. And we're going to fuck that listener.
He is trashed on some type of medication.
Something's going on
with
that.
And it, he completely lost his fucking bearings.
Are people commenting that he was under the influence? Or are they just saying, oh, Larry fucked up again?
Has he been like this consistently on the show, or was it like, on this one episode, he's fucked?
Not that bad, but he gets everything wrong. Everything wrong.
And his dumb questions are... There was one woman that actually... What was she talking about? Being abducted from a car after shopping?
She went to the supermarket, and she was going home, and she got abducted with her groceries, and then the guy took her to some obscure barn or something and raped the shit
raped
out of her.
Raped her and
so
stuff.
Larry's question was...
What happened to the groceries?
He actually said that.
It could be the greatest thing ever said on TV.
Stop it.
And she was like, can we get that audio?
What happened to the groceries?
E-Rock, can you go find that?
God.
It's like,
you got to hear it for yourself.
Did you hear what she's this like, woman just said?
Jesus Christ.
Oh, that is fantastic.
Jesus Christ. Did he rape the groceries, too?
Yeah, what type of groceries? Were the groceries asking for it?
This show's just not going to be the same when he retires, man.
Baguettes can be quite whorish.
Who's going to take over? Is Joy Behar going to take over?
I think some limey.
No, the British guy from America's Got Talent. Yeah.
Piers Morgan. Great.
Piers Morgan or something like that.
Whatever his name
is. I got to watch TV. I'm really out of fucking touch with everything.
I don't watch Larry King. I just,
we just
hear about
clips.
The clips and there's a lot of them.
He's leaving again. Yeah. Everyone's leaving. Oh my God.
Yeah, it's you know, I've never been a big fan of the guy, but it's sad to watch these guys go down because it's just
fantastic to watch.
It's just a marker of time, though.
Yeah.
It's just sad.
Well, it is.
Know? Yeah, it is.
It's there kinda... but for the grace of God and time, that's pretty much what we're looking at. There's your future, fucker. You want to keep that mic slung in front of you? There it is. What are we doing today?
Is he going to become like Ebert, like commentating with a robot voice?
Oh,
like, it's just like, dude, it's just like sad, man. Like, just come
Larry,
on.
Larry will retire and he'll be dead within a year.
Yeah.
That's what happens to these guys.
People.
It kills people.
A year? You only give it a year?
Maybe two.
I'll take a bet with you on
fade into obscurity.
He's going to be one of those guys where he doesn't know what to do with himself because he retired, and then all of a sudden he's just got to die.
I'm going to bet that he dies 6 weeks before he retires.
That's right about now, I think.
Yeah.
Any day now.
Ah.
Wow, he's on something, though, in that clip. That sounded like our old bit where we slow down the audio
for
everybody.
He really is.
E-Rock attempting to run, which is...
Oh, my God, look at him. He's doing the fast shuffle.
Which is greatly appreciated.
Look at the fast shuffle. He's trying to read and walk at the same time. I hope he hits the wall.
Well, what the fuck?
Hey,
bursts
into flames.
E-Rock, Ice Road Trucker made fun of you. Okay, you said? You all right?
No, he's not.
Yeah,
what's the matter, Sam?
Oh, what's the matter?
I'm just saying he looks very, very flustered.
Wow, something's wrong with you.
Because he's been asked to do things.
Your blood pressure high? What's the matter, E-Rock? You all right?
E-Rock, what happened?
You're flustered.
There's a Oh, shit, he just hit Sam.
Ow!
There's a problem.
What's wrong?
Nothing. I ran back to get that to make sure I had the right clips.
See, it's like very... So
you are flustered.
Yeah, a little bit.
What
happened?
Why?
He's being asked to do the second
what happened?
Thing he's been asked to do today.
You can't run back and forth anymore, huh?
What's wrong with your jaw?
It's been...
Oh, overworked?
Yeah. It's been what?
Well, what do you say?
It's been clicking.
Lately, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah. You just heard a crack, but
you got TMJ
every now and then
or
just...
something. What are they called? TMZ,
TMS.
PBJ's pretty funny.
PBJ.
Yeah, he's got a sword J.
Chip. What's it from?
I don't know. Just...
Yeah, did you?
Okay, sandwiches.
Are you part Eskimo?
No.
Why? What happened?
Look at his eyes.
German-Irish.
German-Irish?
Well, let me tell you my...
Proud
maybe just
friend.
Sleepy. Your eyes look Eskimo-ish today.
Mm.
All right. Well, let me... thank you, Ron.
There you go. clicking jaw and everything. There he goes.
He's got an ailment.
Open his mouth, it's kind of like fucking, a velociraptor claw.
The fucking defeat on Opie's face. He's going, whatever.
I was hoping we were going to find out something new and then we could beat him up for an hour. I was praying he was going to say, God, how did you know I was Eskimo?
The clicking
jaws. Here come the jokes. All right, here we go. Larry King for Joe DeRosa. Actually, it's one of our favorites. This Larry King gets to the bottom of things, asking the crucial questions. He's talking to a rape victim here.
What was that accent, Stephen? Where is he from?
That's a Marine accent. It's been my experience that the Jarhead Clan almost has their own vernacular, their own accent. I'd say there's a bit of Virginia in there, a little Tidewater Virginia, and maybe a few other things as well. It's made up.
You remember the movie A Few Good Men, which Jack Nicholson played that incredible part? Well, Stephen Lang did it on Broadway, and he was incredible with that great line, right? You wouldn't know the truth.
You can't handle the truth.
You wouldn't know the truth.
Good clip, but that's not the clip.
What famous is line, I wouldn't know the line.
Yeah, what's that famous line? Play it for the first time, Sam. Asshole.
I love that movie. What did he say? Did the what happened to the groceries? Was that the line?
What was that? I remember that.
The track listing doesn't match up. It was supposed to be. I don't know why it's not.
I could have been a container.
I'm gonna make you an offer you can't understand.
I think this is it. I think this is the setup. Larry King gets to the bottom of things, asking the crucial questions about a rape victim.
As I came out of the grocery store and got my car, Philip knocked on my window and said, I can't seem to get my car to start. It's cold. Do you think you'd give me a ride? You know, which way are you going? And, of course, he was going to go anyway, any which way I was going. And so I did.
Why did you let him in the car?
I don't know. It was the worst decision I've ever made, I think. It truly was.
What happened when he got in?
When he got in, I filled his hands with a lot of food that they had in the front seat anyway. I tried to engage him and
he was holding your food?
Mm-hmm. He was. I tried to engage him in small conversation on the trip. I tried to stay on the main street, and when I got ready to turn, he said, well, where I'm staying is right up the road here. So I took him a little further up, and then just turned around the corner and pulled over, and he slammed my head into the steering wheel and pulled out handcuffs. He took my keys out, threw them on the floor, and pulled out handcuffs and handcuffed me and said, I just want a piece of ass. If you be good, you won't get hurt.
What did he do with the food?
He put it on the floor, I guess. I don't know. I
was just... Jesus Christ.
It's just this horrifying moment.
Jesus Christ.
He prepared it, Larry.
What did he do with the food?
She was looking for some compassion. Hear how she answered that? Yeah. Like, are you fucking kidding me?
He put it on the floor, dummy.
Yeah.
What do you think?
He got it again.
Oh my God. Reenacted 9.5 weeks with it. It was very romantic. No, he shoved the zucchini up my pussy. Yeah.
Her giving details couldn't be more dramatic. Oh my God. Just couldn't be more dramatic. And this is what this fool does.
And said, I just want a piece of ass. If you be good, you won't get hurt.
What did he do with the food?
He put it on the floor, I guess. I don't know. I was just...
I guess. I don't know.
I was being raped. Yes.
Right.
I was being cuffed. Really
at this point, he had a fist in my ass, Larry. I don't know.
What was happening to my
fucking... I can't answer you.
Yogurt.
Well, Larry, that was actually the payoff for the rape, was he made a bolognese afterwards. That part I appreciated.
Yes. He had a CVS card. What an asshole.
What? Do you like Trader Joe's?
Paper or plastic?
Jesus Christ.
The best part, though, how her voice goes up. I don't know, Larry.
Yeah, I don't know, Larry. I was
kind of busy hoping that I was going to survive this ordeal.
Was there anything heavy on top of the eggs? Comment. Did you notice while your teeth were being caved in off the steering wheel?
Were you angry with the bag boy for squishing your bread?
Don't you hate when the bag opens and the apples fall all over the floor? You can never get that one as you're driving to the hospital after a brutal rape. Comment? Were you as bruised as one of those apples after he finished with you?
The only crime worse than rape is when the ice cream starts to melt. Yeah. You get it under the freezer.
We're Were you concerned about the Häagen-Dazs?
Was the heat on the milk? Did it sour the milk? Did you notice that while you were being dehumanized and comment?
I think we got one more from him. If we're going down this road, we might as well do
yeah,
this.
Yeah, we might as well.
Then it was this. Same interview.
All right, now you're in a car. You're handcuffed. How does this happen? How was he able to consummate this?
Well, you mean how was he able to handcuff me?
Yeah, no, rape
no, no, no. What hole did he stick his cock in? Mouth, cunt, or ass? Comment. How was he able to consummate this?
Consummate? It's a marriage.
He had you handcuffed. How did he fuck you?
He did not say consummate.
She goes, what, you mean handcuff me? And he goes, no, rape you.
No, rape you.
That's
how
delicate.
How did he rape you?
That's how
See,
you...
He put his cock inside me against my will. That's rape.
That's forced it in.
Yeah, that's how you do a delicate interview with a rape victim. Yeah. No, rape.
How did he get his nipples played with while he had sex with you? I can't keep an erection without it. Comment?
Well, Larry, the rape felt like this interview.
Without the doddering.
Well, you mean how was he able to handcuff me?
Yeah, no, rape you.
Oh, well, he took me to a mini warehouse.
Oh, he took you out of there.
Yes, he transferred me after he handcuffed me. He transferred me into the passenger seat. He pulled a leather strap out of his hair, and he tied my head to my knees.
Were you fearing for your life?
I was. I thought I was dead.
No, I knew I would be let go after the rape, Larry. He was taking me to a location. I knew I would be fine after that. Or they always rape you and let you go while you see their face. What was stored in the warehouse? Do you know what kind of rent they were paying there? Is it unionized? Comment.
Did you ever see Law Abiding Citizen? Was it like that part in the movie?
Just like it. I like how he asked her about that. Then he raped you repeatedly and just kept fucking you.
Yeah.
Deep dicking you.
Yes.
Oh, had you evacuated or when he put it in your butthole, did he get shit on his dick and underwear? How did he consummate it with shit on his dick?
Consummate.
That smell always kills my erection.
Until I realize it's from me.
Yeah. Were you fearing for your life?
I was. I thought I was dead.
And then he what? Raped you repeatedly?
Uh-huh.
Uh-huh. Yeah, Larry.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah, Larry.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah.
What? Larry, what?
Yeah.
Sorry.
Jesus Christ almighty, man. That's fucking insane. Now, here's the question I have is why... I mean, they shoved Carson out. And Carson was still killing and doing all right.
Yeah, absolutely.
He was still running the show. Why have they not shoved this fucking guy off the air yet?
They kept him on the air way too fucking long.
Because his ratings were still up there, but in the last year or two, you know, not so much. So finally they got an exit strategy for him. We have a whole disc of his
fuck-ups.
His fuck-ups.
And his Motley
and
Crue
we got a new one to add. We got a new one to add.
That's a great one.
Today.
He's walking off again.
Jesus, Larry. Your show's being seen all over the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, man is walking on the moon. As I'm watching, man is on the moon. Astounding. Look, Walter Cronkite has a tear in his eye. Wait, he's dead.
Walter Cronkite has been raped in a warehouse. Wait a minute.
What did you do with the groceries after the Tet Offensive announcement?
That's right.
When Johnson said the war is unwinnable, or when you did, who said that?
After Kennedy got shot, he interviewed Governor Connolly. Do you still have the hat you were holding?
What happened to the hat?
That's a great hat. Who cleaned the car? How much did that cost?
Do you still do tricks with the magic bullet? Like make it your thumb and detach it. Yes. Or tell a child it's his nose.
How much did it cost to fill in the concretes that got knocked out by the bullet that hit James K? Was that a unionized job? Comment. Abraham Zapruder. How much do you pay your secretary that you were there with?
Oh, man. Jesus. What an adult.
All right, where did you buy the film? For the camera. For the film of the Kennedy assassination.
When Kevin Costner videotaped Kennedy getting shot. How much did he charge you for that footage?
What kind of books were in the book depository?
Do you think Oswald sat back and just read a little after he shot the president? Comment. What did he read? Harry Potter? His books are very popular.
Fucking A.
Yes. Was it Kentucky bluegrass on the grassy knoll or a feather lead bent?
Why is Noel spelled with a K? Comment.
He's fucked.
That's great.
What is he doing?
That's great TV. He's done, and that incontinent asshole has had his dick in hotter snatch than I'll ever see in my life.
He just keeps fucking getting married, having kids.
Oh, my God.
I don't even know. What's the Chance? Isn't that the last kid he had?
Yeah.
It's my kid, Chance.
Oh. He had that kid, too, that he, like, gave up for adoption, and then the kid came back and found him. Did you hear about that?
Oh, really?
Jeez. Yeah.
That's a great story.
I forgot about you. It's like, fuck.
So much better than my adoption story.
You're adopted?
Yeah, I'm adopted. But, you know.
That explains a lot.
Yeah, I know.
It really does.
But my parents were immigrants. It's like, you know.
Oh, wow.
They work in some fucking Aladdin market somewhere selling apples, probably. You know, but this
Have you ever tried to find them?
No.
Do you want to?
No, for that reason, because I know they were immigrants. I don't want to find. I'm afraid they're going to be creepy, fucking weird, foreign.
Just immigrant, foreign, not American.
Yeah, yeah.
And like, then you're once removed.
Please help us. Ugh, go fuck yourselves.
You are John DeRosa, the famous comedian. We need your help.
We saw you on the premium blend.
We need your help.
Yeah,
You got to find them for that reason. Then you can
find them. I don't want
them. We are Muslims.
I don't imagine they're Muslim.
Jesus Christ. Forget it. I don't want to know. I don't want to know. I don't need it in my life. Oh, I got enough shit going on.
I would have to know.
Fucking strapping bombs to you.
Yeah. I got to go over their house in the holidays and eat not regular holiday shit.
Ramadan.
Yeah. Have you ever had this dessert? It's calf's liver wrapped in sweet peas.
With that, we say hi to Joe DeRosa. What are you promoting, Joe, before we move into Jocktober?
I'm at Helium this week. Starting tomorrow through Saturday night, and Amy Schumer and I are co-headlining Thursday.
Oh, that's the big
Saturday.
Show we said to come back and promote.
Yeah.
It's finally here. My God. Yeah, you got to go see Joe in Philly.
Yeah, I'm excited about
it. Helium Comedy Club starting tomorrow night.
Oh, yeah. People are saying tomorrow, your birth name was Joe Atta.
I understand my dad was a pilot.
Tomorrow's Wednesday, Joe.
Yeah, I start tomorrow. I'm alone tomorrow, and then it's
Wednesday,
Amy and I together
all the way
Thursday
through the
Saturday.
Weekend.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
Yeah, it's a long week.
It's Jocktober.
This is awesome.
A celebration of craptastic radio from around this great nation of ours.
Great. Oh, God, this is great. Thank you.
So turn up this turd-tacular radio.
Oh, my God, I can't believe it.
It's Jocktober.
Jocktober. Got that right.
Jocktober. And it's a surprise today,
I guess? We can't even look at the tracks. I know what show we're doing. That's about all.
You know the show. Okay.
Don't look at those tracks.
What location are we looking at?
We're going down to Richmond, Virginia.
Yes, we head to Richmond, Virginia.
Old Virginia.
For iPower 92.1 interactive hip-hop and R&B.
What does that mean?
Yeah, what is that?
You know, it's like when the iPod and the iPad and the iPhone, they got popular. Couple of radio stations throw the I in front of their name.
No, I mean, what's interactive about?
They got a website.
Okay. All right.
Let's get right into
this. Well, is it a small I, lowercase I?
Yes, it is. It's a lowercase
I.
It seems like copyright infringement.
Yeah, it does.
Don't get right into it. Don't play the first track yet. It needs a little setup.
Wow. Go fuck us.
Sam's very confident about today's Jocktober,
really
by
is.
The way. Because yesterday was a disaster. That's John and Jeff. We couldn't make shit out of that.
But John and Jeff need to be highlighted for history's sake.
That's true. It was tiring for everybody.
But the thing about this Jocktober is I've been following this all month long of Jocktober.
Really?
Because a news story broke on Jocktober 1st of this year.
Mm-hmm.
It came right out of, in fact, it was on the iPower website. That's where the news article first broke that stated this. Our commissioner was robbed in our very own parking lot last night. A briefcase with money for our next video was stolen.
They're not doing this, bitch.
It was stolen.
No. No! They're not doing this bit.
The iPower 92
The Fugitive.
The dog bit
they're
me.
They're not doing the Fugitive bit.
This was Jocktober 1st.
You can't do how this many, How many stations have we featured doing this exact same, something's been stolen, there's a Fugitive bit?
I mean, at this point, almost, over a dozen.
Yeah, almost every city.
Holy shit.
People called in from all over the country saying my local station is doing the Fugitive.
At this point, we don't have many details, but being in the middle of this touchy situation, we will try our best to keep you informed.
Oh, good. Oh, very touchy situation.
Does, Joe, do you know about this?
The hacks.
The I don't know what the Fugitive is.
The Fugitive steals money from the radio station, and then it's your job as the listener to find the Fugitive.
To track them down
and then the Fugitive
find them.
Has to call the radio station three times a day, usually when people are listening to the the station the most.
Yeah, okay. On the
and gets
hour.
Clues.
And clues, okay. And then if you find him,
you get
he
money.
Doesn't get arrested for stealing.
No.
You get the money.
Does anybody really believe it? They couldn't.
I couldn't imagine.
Did you guys hear this
But they really play it up like, you know, this has been stolen. Oh, boy.
Oh, so they really try to make you. So it's not like a goofy game like find the Fugitive. They're really trying to make you think.
They try to make it like this was stolen.
They have fake
it's your job.
Press conferences with all the sales staff making believe they're part of the media. It's horrendous how bad this bit.
Well, is. I don't know how you guys already knew all this because October 4th,
yeah.
The station website posted that the Fugitive has stolen $5,000.
Another cheap station. They wouldn't go with the 10 grand.
No,
huh?
5 grand.
They only have 5 grand for this horseshit promotion?
Here is your chance to solve the mystery, find the Fugitive, and get the reward.
What's the reward?
$5,000.
Yeah, 5 lousy thousand.
But wait, why is the reward as much as was stolen?
Right.
Then well, the Fugitive stole $5,000 in cash, and the station wants it back. And to make sure they get it back, they're offering a $5,000 reward.
That doesn't seem very
So why don't they just say, fuck the $5,000 and play the stupid
hits? Why don't they say he stole $10,000 and then they're giving away half if you get it back?
$5,000.
What fucking assholes.
Good news, though. Danny has just brought it to my attention. They have a iPower 92.1 iChat.
A fugitive chat room.
A Fugitive chat room. Is anybody in there right now discussing the Fugitive?
Radio fucking sucks.
Isn't it the worst?
That's why we can't do Jocktober anymore.
There's 9 people. I am one.
Very good. What do you want to write?
Oh, I'm just telling people that my balls are full of cum.
Okay, good. Good.
Well, there's a way to catch the Fugitive.
Wait, how do we get on the website? On
just
the
go to
room?
iPowerRichmond.com. It's right on the front. It's not on the front. If you go to, hang on, let me figure out how
to. Is it
I
easy
this.
To get into the chat
yeah,
room?
Yeah, you just go to iPowerRichmond.com.
We've
got
to get a couple hundred people in right now.
And you got to click over to the Fugitive page.
Okay.
So you just click on the little Fugitive thing.
Okay, I'm going right now.
Yeah. There you go.
Power Richmond.
That's how it works when there's an actual manhunt going on. There's a website with a chat room about it.
How many people are in there now?
It's loading up.
Okay. Where's the Fugitive? Oh, there it is.
You in there yet, Ant?
I'm almost there. I gotta move this away a little bit. Hold on.
If you listen to the station weekdays at 10 a.m., 12 p.m., 2 p.m., 4 p.m., and 6 p.m., new clues will be given as the Fugitive calls
that's
in.
How fucking terrible.
It's unbelievable.
How do I get a game?
Who thinks this is a good radio bit?
Can I make a name?
Sure.
Yeah, I don't think you could use profanity, though.
No, of course
not. I know, but I just want to make a name. How do I make one?
Try typing something.
Edit nickname. Okay, right there. Here it is.
Racist jerk.
I'm going to be...
Make your nickname Anthony from Opie and Anthony.
Oh, that's silly.
Yeah.
I'm going to be... someone's the Fugitive.
Whoa, that could be him.
That could be him right there.
Uh-oh.
Clues. But you have to ask him in person.
Club Soda... Kenny.
Perfect.
That's me. I'm Club Soda Kenny. And I'm going to write... Oh, they don't allow obscenities?
No.
Can I go get around it by writing like...
No, just...
F...
Make believe Club Soda Kenny is gay and you're looking for cock in the chat room.
C, and then I'll do that.
Or...
Fuck. No. Pussy. I want cock.
There it is.
Are you putting the dashes and things in? Or are you just writing the words?
Gotta get online.
Yeah!
We got people in the chat room now.
It's loading up.
I can't get in for some reason.
Yeah, where
Ted Sheckler's in.
Oh, good. Ted's made it in there. That's good.
Oh yeah.
You want to play the
Uncle
first?
Uncle Paul, Larry King,
That's
Tool
great.
Bag,
Tool Bag,
Black Ball Liquor, Jew, Whack Bag Fairy 2000, In Person, Jerk It, Lil Jimmy. Nut Liquor.
They're all in there.
Erat Chugs Hellman's.
That's true.
Oh, my God.
Opie's Thumb.
How come there's no chips or something?
Wow, it's really... Look at how quickly...
It's filling
the
up.
The chat is moving.
Well, look, we'll help them find the... How do you say it?
The fugitive.
The fugitive.
Yes.
Did I say it right?
Fugitive. That time you did.
Fugitive. So let's play the first track to get this thing going as people enter the fugitive chat room.
Yes.
Classic Lil Jon, the East Side Boys. Where the East Side?
This is Nick Cannon's audio.
Where the East Side Boys?
This is Nick Cannon.
iPower 92.
You sure? Sounds just like Nick Cannon.
I think you're getting racial.
Classic Lil Jon, the East Side Boys. Where the East Side Boys at now, Skills?
On the West Side.
The Skills Radio, iPowerRichmond.com.
Yeah.
A-plus Skills in the building.
Uh-huh.
Like I was saying earlier, Skills, I got to get on these iPower lines and find out where this $5,000 fugitive is. They're expected to call in this hour, okay?
Okay. All right.
Let's see what's up. iPower, what's good?
Yeah, I'm trying to win the money.
I'm trying to find the fugitive. You got to call me back, okay?
All right.
All right. Skills Radio, it's iPower. What's up?
A-plus.
Well.
It's the same voice. See, I thought, stupid me, that it was actually someone from the radio station, but they even farm out the voice. It's one person that calls all these
Jesus Christ.
Stations.
Jesus Christ.
Radio sucks.
It's so bad. It's a bandit who's
with
on the loose.
Fucking scream voice. Do you like scary movies, Sydney?
Have you sat through one of these yet? We do it every year.
What, Jocktober?
No, The Fugitive.
No, I've never gotten
Wait
a fugitive.
Hear this horseshit.
Yeah, I'm excited.
Such an appropriate name. You clearly are smarter than the fool who let me take the money from him.
Really?
Ooh. I hope you slept well this weekend. Now, for all of your listeners, let me remind you of the rules.
Oh, the rules.
Nobody is ever going to call you and say that they're me. I'm never going to tell you to go anyplace and try to meet me.
Oh my God! And they have to lawyer up.
Shit! Yeah,
and,
yeah.
And they can't even do the bit properly because they have to lawyer up and make sure the person that is playing the fugitive doesn't get hit over the head with a pipe.
Yeah, I was gonna say, what are they gonna do when some crazed fans form a vigilante mob and ass rape this guy for the briefcase?
That's why you can't get the wrong direction and say the fugitive told you to go somewhere.
That's why they're giving all the rules of the contest. It used to be good enough you just had to have the rules posted on a website. Now the fugitive has to give the rules, which totally takes you out of the bit.
You know who I want to see win this? Paul Kersey. I'm Paul Kersey.
I
like that you did the gun.
Yes, he
shoots. All you have to do is listen at 10, 12, 2, 4, 6. Take everything that I say, write it down, look at it from all sorts of different angles.
Yes.
Think about it, put it together.
What?
Oh,
I think it's a woman,
God.
Too, which
this
is bothering me.
Fuck what they believes this garbage.
And it's so bad. It's been done so many times. It's hack.
They can't even, like, keep it to your imagination. Now they're just spoon-feeding you the rules for bullshit contest.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to call it 10, 12.
Right.
Like,
yeah.
It just fucking... Terrestrial Radio deserves the fucking dick it's been taking. They deserve it.
Think about it. Put it together. I could be anybody. I could be the person in the cubicle next to you. I could be the guy at Starbucks who gives you your coffee every day.
Really?
I could be the girl who is the crossing guard at your kid's school.
Huh?
Ask everybody you see, are you the iPower 92-1 $5,000 fugitive? If you ask me, and you ask me wrong, I'll just look at you like you're the fool that you are. So shut up and listen. I am the fugitive, the scoundrel you seek. Around the Commonwealth, you search and you peek. Ask all who you meet, whether short or quite tall. Are you the iPower 92-1 $5,000 fugitive? And walk away with a haul. There's clues in there. Think about it. I'll talk to you in 2 hours.
Two hours.
Hey, wait.
Fuck it. the fucking
go, Jimmy,
branding
go.
That regular radio
go, Jimmy.
Fucking sucks. Hey, here's a good way to get our station name out there. So you have to say the station name.
Well, yeah, what do does that matter in the end? And no one's going to do it for $5,000.
Fucking horrible.
If you had a real cash prize, then maybe you would get people doing it. But not for five. Who's going to do that shit for $5,000?
The dumb fucks that listen to that station will do it. They're and I don't mean that racially because it's a hip-hop station. I'm just saying if you fucking think...
I wish...
if you think that's entertaining, you would do it for $5,000.
You're not right, Joe.
Really?
That's how sad it really is. They know this shit doesn't work in the end, but they have nothing else to do. They don't know what to do.
I just...
It does create a buzz.
It doesn't create nothing. Shit.
What did it do for fucking K-Rock? 92.3 now? It put him on the map.
You can't... It's really fucking sad. Like, you can't... Everything is staged. And like you were saying, they spoon-feed you. They spoon-feed you spoon-feedable material. It's like you don't have to spoon-feed horseshit. It's horseshit for a fucking reason.
Right.
And then they spoon-feed you the horseshit. Well, it's like everything.
You can't even do a prank where people would be like, wow, is something going on? Like, for a second.
You can't. You can't do a fucking prank. Every prank call now is staged. Well, these things are all staged because it's fucking. Well, everything is so fucking emasculated and pussified now. You can't fucking do anything.
And this bit would almost work if you just threw it out there. But as soon as you start giving the rules, people are like, oh, okay, more fake dumb radio.
It's
you
know terrible. What I mean? It's terrible.
Well,
it's,
like. That's exactly what George Harrison's gutter hat has said.
Oh, we're in the chat room.
Yes.
Is that one of the names?
Yes, George Harrison's gutter hat. His hat with the gutters on it to catch his goopy brain.
George Harrison's gutter hat.
Should we just play the next track there?
You know, somebody has to be noticing all the people in the chat. Are there more people in the chat room than there were?
Quite a few.
Well, let's play the next track because we got to move on because we got Carrie from Mythbusters coming in.
Well, we're highlighting an entire month's worth of clues, so now we're going to fast forward to clue number 5.
South Carolina 92.1 in active hip-hop, and R&B, home of that Russ Paul Morning Show, and the station on the hunt for the $5,000 fugitive. Hello, who's on the line?
Yeah, I have a question.
Yes.
Am I supposed to just walk up to a random person and ask them, do they have the money?
Yes.
Because this can be dangerous.
That could be very dangerous.
Ask them.
But just do it in a nice way. Don't just walk up to somebody and snatch them up and do it. Just say, hey, excuse me, are you the iPower 92.1 $5,000 fugitive?
But that can be anybody in Richmond.
You're right. But it could be somebody in Richmond, and you could win that reward.
That's right. But, okay, can I request a song?
Yeah, what you want to hear, baby?
So the boy blowing me kisses.
I'll get it on for you in a little bit, baby.
A request.
Thank you.
I'll power you down with the king.
Why? Did you notice how she lost interest and said, well, can you just play me a fucking song, please?
Just play a song, motherfucker.
Why would the fugitive steal money and then give it back and risk prison to someone who said... The station name. Like, radio is so, as an industry, is so fucking, it's shit.
It stinks.
It's a bunch of fucking cornball, uncreative people. The morning show didn't say, hey, that's some fucking faggot.
Oh, no, boss. A consultant and a boss coming in and going, hey, there's a great promotion that's going around the nation.
This is like the number one promotion
in radio.
We're
picking this up.
Out there.
It's the few. We're going to do the few. Yeah. They probably called a big meeting and goes, hey, staff, I just want to let you know, we're doing the fugitive gag. And everybody's got to clap. Yep, we're doing it. Here's how it works.
For $5,000.
Big meeting with all of them at the conference table. Well, and some uncreative fucking management standing there. Ugh.
Yeah. Pal, you down with the king.
Hey, how are you doing?
Is this somebody faking like they're the iPower 92.1 $5,000 fugitive? Because we need to keep these lines open for the real person.
I am the person.
Oh, has got any street
mess
cred
with me? Sometimes, Tut, I get angry. You don't want to see that side of me.
Did I make you angry?
Well, Tiffany made me angry. She
if
told her sister Ebony that I wasn't real.
Whoa!
Very real.
Hold up. I just talked to those ladies during the hard drive at fire. Where are you?
Oh, at work. listening.
And work. Work.
Right. Oh, I shouldn't I say know much one part more of the clue. Who lets people listen to iPower? There's a clue right there.
Because, you know all those wily comic book criminals have day jobs.
Yeah. I know one part of the clue.
Yeah.
They're white.
Yeah. We can look for the Riddler around Gotham or at Office Depot.
Yes.
Where he works a 9-to-5.
He's working.
We need much more than that. Who lets people listen to iPower at work? There's a clue right there. And here's another clue. Oh. Dinner time. The chase has left me hungry. If you're at the Arches, two cheeseburgers may help you find me. Oh, nummy, gotta go.
Arches?
What?
Arches?
Arches.
My favorite part about the promotion is that you can tell when people really stop caring and when the station gets desperate. Because he just said, I'll be at the McDonald's tonight.
Right.
Yeah. So if anybody really wanted the $5,000, they'd just go to McDonald's and do it.
What are they doing down there at McDonald's? Drinking milkshakes, I assure you.
I hope that's what happens to the fugitive. Hope fucking Steve Buscemi shoots him.
McDonald's.
We gotta
leaving dinner to go to McDonald's. Fucking scumbag father-in-law.
Dude.
I love that guy.
We got to move through this because we got Mythbusters coming in here, Carrie. What's the next one there, Sam? That was clue number 5.
Yeah, we fast forward even further to clue number 12.
Oh.
Mm. 12 o'clock throwback with DJ Flavor Inside Skills Radio on iPower 92.1 Interactive Hip Hop and R&B.
Yeah, your boy Skills in the building, Skills Radio right here on iPower. Y'all know what it do.
Flavor on the set. We in the building. And I'm going to scan these lines for the fugitive, man. So let's see what's up.
Yeah, it's about that time. I mean, they supposed to be calling, right?
Allegedly.
Okay, let's check the lines. Let's see what it do.
All right.
iPower. I have a question really quick.
All right, hold on the line for me. I'm looking for the fugitive right now, okay?
It's more important stuff.
Right. iPower, are you the fugitive?
They're looking for the fugitive.
iPower, is this the fugitive?
Yes, I'm taking a break from chatting with my new friend, Chris. Chris, you have a lot of confidence. I'll just say that. Now, look up and down as you pass people on the street. If they have pet hair on their clothes, the money you will not meet.
Not.
Gotta run. Quick.
Ah. So they don't have a pet?
He doesn't have a pet. Or she doesn't
shit.
Have a pet. What?
I'm just taking a break. I need to be quick because my boss is coming.
This fucking I can't even hate the radio show. It's the fucking
they're forced to do it.
It's their bosses and the promotion. They don't, sucks.
They can't think of their own shit, so they get these bits from a company. Yeah.
And it's because
you know how lame that is? You're supposed to be hiring people that know how to talk and might be a little creative, and you can't even come up with your own shit.
It's because they have fucking...
That's what's even more enraging. This bit's being done all over the country. Fuck them. I hate the radio show. Because your path that you take leads you there. You know what I mean? It's like that's where they led themselves. Fuck them. You wear the fucking armband, you march for Hitler. Fuck them.
If you got a gig and you're doing a job, and the station's doing okay, and the fucking boss, and the station's only doing okay because your fucking pussy boss is making you play from a playlist that tested positive with a focus group. As a guy, your hands are kind of tied. So they come in, they go, we're doing this bit because it's going to get the fucking numbers up for everybody. You can't say no because you have to get your numbers. It's like, it's a bad spot to be in. And I'm not saying the radio show is good, but I fucking despise the people who make them do it. And the fucking, and the chick calling in stinks.
Oh, terrible. Terrible.
And also, it's like if your station's not making a lot of money and somebody steals a prize pack,
you need that money back.
That is a good point.
Although you're going to now give it to the listener, which makes no fucking sense. They can't even figure that
shit really out. They really can't.
Where are we at there? We're up to clue number 27. How many clues do they have?
This is still not even close to right now. This is weeks ago.
iPower, hello, is this the Fuge?
All right.
Fuge. Fuge.
Let me answer the fucking phone properly.
It's the Fuge.
iPower, hello, is this the Fuge?
Well, I was going to remain silent and just sit here until it got awkward. But no, I'll talk.
Oh.
I'm off to some lunch. And by day. The name of the hood sounds like something that Santa might say. Bye.
Ho ho. What would Santa say? Get off my lap. I spilled something in there. Yeah, feels really good. I forgot I met Joe already. Kiss him on his shoulders. Soft shoulders.
Like what shoulders?
Like a lady.
We have six more tracks.
That's right.
How are we going to get through this?
We're trying to track the future.
We don't have to. Can we finish it later?
Yeah, we certainly can.
This is terrific. I'd hate to rush through
this. We'll do one more track, then we'll take a break, then we'll get Carrie from Mythbusters.
Sure.
Okay, because we got to.
It'll be halfway through the bit.
The more clues we get, the closer we'll get.
Shut up. All right. I don't feel like playing today.
Okay. What's this one? With Jocktober. You guys don't feel like playing anymore.
Well, we're going to do show and tell.
Sure, we are.
Before the end of today's show, by the way.
Okay.
What's the next track? There, Sam.
Clue number 30, the Fuge has been... Number 30, the Fuge has been following some of the DJs around.
Carrie just signed in, though. All right, we're going to take a break, Sam.
What about the track? We just played everybody's...
How about
right.
We don't come back?
We'll get back to this.
Everyone's going to be very excited then.
For what? Carrie, of course.
No. For the Fugitive.
Waiting all morning for this. And then more...
By the way... The Ice Road Trucker gave me a kiss, and Danny thinks that he can get a kiss from Carrie, and I don't think it's possible.
The Ice Road Trucker kissed you?
You didn't see that? On his head.
He gave me a kiss. I got kissed by an Ice Road Trucker.
Carrie will kiss Danny.
Let's see.
That's true.
Yeah, we'll get it done.
Let's see.
I'll be like, oh, can I have a kiss? Humanity on the virus. Serious XM.
All right, we got Joe DeRosa in studio playing Helium Comedy Club starting tomorrow night, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, down there in Philly. Make sure you go see Joe DeRosa, very, very funny guy. And you're doing it with Amy Schumer, right?
Yeah.
Sorry. Try again.
Yes, it'll be fun.
All right.
And walking down the hall, Danny's favorite. Danny's losing his mind. He's been losing his mind for the last couple of days.
I don't know. My heart rate just shot up like double.
Carrie Byron from Mythbusters. Danny is losing his mind.
Poor Danny.
She is his favorite of all time.
It's
going to
be embarrassing for Danny.
Look at you.
I'm already hot and sweaty.
Hi, Carrie.
How are you?
Welcome to the Opie and Anthony Show.
Hi.
He's very... You might want to watch out on your right there. He's very nervous.
I'm trying not to look. If I look, it's going to be over.
He is your biggest fan by far.
Smitten.
Carrie, I'm...
Can't look at her.
He's losing his mind.
Are you kidding me?
This is not a joke.
Oh, my God.
This is not a joke. He's losing his mind.
Nice to meet you. I'm Jim. Oh, she has such a nice handshake, Danny.
He really is losing his mind.
Yeah, Danny has a crush on you.
I promise he doesn't bite. Can you at least hug him and get it out of the way? Just hug him. Hug him and then we can do a real interview.
Oh my God.
See, I told you she smelled good.
I told you.
Showered and everything.
We all love you, but he really loves you.
He's crazy.
Like in a creepy way. He's all right.
He's all right, though. Making me feel very comfortable.
I've already made sure to like just hide in my little corner so I don't get too close or no sharp movements or anything.
Look how ready he's getting.
Yeah. I could feel it.
He very rarely likes girls who are over 18. It's kind of nice to see an actual adult.
Well, why don't we ask Danny, why do you like her so much?
Look
at her. Eh?
I'm a big fan of the show in the first place. I love Mythbusters. I've seen, I think, probably every one 1,000 times.
Yeah, I love the show.
But it's just it's the whole package, you know? It's the beauty, it's the brains, it's the whole thing right there.
Now she's in red.
If I could probably really creep her out, because I know you did some event in D.C. at the mall over there over the weekend, and I was crazy enough, because I didn't know we were getting you in studio at that point. I had considered driving into D.C. just to go.
Jesus. That's great.
Seven hours there and back.
Danny, why don't you just pull out a piece of her hair from your pocket?
If she's willing to part with some, I'll definitely keep it in my wallet.
If Lee Malvo and John Muhammad showed up at her D.C. event, she would have been less freaked out.
You are really a ghoul.
Well, I didn't know we were going to get her in. And I, was
I know.
Like,
yeah, yeah, you know, I knew you were in D.C. and you were staying at the Radisson, so I was tempted to go and knock on your door and invite you to the show. He's usually not this creepy.
Yeah, he really is. I've never seen him like this.
He keeps himself very shy.
Yeah.
With you any guys guests, really love him. Very hot and sweaty. Like this.
Yeah.
Oh, we're just getting started.
Yeah.
Do you get that a lot? I mean, you must. I mean, you know, being a very beautiful woman on what is typically just a couple of guys, you must get this all the time.
No, not really. I mean, we're very insular. I mean, we have just the few of us working, very skeleton crew, and I'm kind of a sister to them now. They don't look at me like that.
Yeah, but right. I think the fans, though, because you are getting some geeky guys that like watching the show, although the show does cross over many people. But
you mean the non-geeky people?
Is some geeky, non-geeky people, but you get a lot of geeky people, and you are like queen of the geeky people.
I'll
people
take it. That's a compliment. I love that.
Because I won't put it as mushy as Danny put it, but it is very good to see a woman such as yourself doing things that are kind of cool and mechanical and geeky and
kind
fun.
Kind of cool?
Kind of cool.
I shoot.
No, they're very, very cool.
50 caliber gun.
I
One
know.
One day, the next day I go to the bomb range. I have the coolest job
I own
ever.
That rifle.
Over.
I own that. A Barrett 50 cal.
Yeah.
I
really?
Take it out to Calverton. Aren't they, don't they like hurt your head to shoot?
I wear earplugs.
Yeah, no, but I mean, it like the concussion makes me feel like you've been punched in the face. Like, it's such a, maybe I'm just a pussy.
You are, because, you know.
I like it. I like that feeling.
It's
a
great,
strange feeling
it's
you
a
can't
concussion.
Explain.
Yeah, like, things move around you. If you have stuff on tables, like, 3 feet away, it just flies off the
you
table.
You should get along very well. I like this.
Carrie's chopped down a tree with a minigun. What have you done? How many trees have you took out?
No. Not many, but yeah. I did blow up a watermelon with
with Gallagher's
caliber. Some guy was holding
desert
it.
Eagle.
You were aiming at the fruit.
No, a Desert Eagle, 50 cal Desert Eagle.
That's
fun
pretty
to
impressive.
Shoot, yeah, you guys have gotten into shooting. You've gotten to shoot some fun guns. I know Jamie does a lot of the shooting when you were doing the ballistics into the pool, which was very surprising.
Yeah,
I
thought
know,
the higher caliber was going to go deeper than the smaller caliber. But
so now you
go
know.
Go figure that out.
When you're
I
being
know.
Chased by villains or
yeah.
good guys, and in you know some cases,
yeah.
die.
Were you now what was the initial thing? Because years ago when the show first started, it was just Adam and Jamie,
mm-hmm.
two knock around guys, just building stuff and blowing things up and everything. What was the basic idea behind bringing you on board and the other people that came on after that?
Well, I've kind of been there since day one because I took an internship with MythBusters. Well, actually, with Jamie as a special effects artist on my first day as an intern. Was the first day of filming. So you can kind of see in some of the early episodes when they pan across, I'll be like laughing in the background
really?
And that kind of
Never
stuff.
Never noticed that.
And then, I mean, it was really just kind of a small show on a cable channel. You know, I didn't think anybody was watching, and they happened to need a woman's backside for one of their...
Yes, the
yes,
famous
that was
first.
For the plane yeah, toilet
yes.
myth.
Yes,
yes, yes, yes.
That was
can
the first,
get stuff
that was the first
on
thing
the plane
she did.
Toilet?
Yeah, so, you know, hey, I was the only girl at the shop. They
did
didn't
you have
want
any
Adam's
reservations
butt.
About that?
No, I really thought nobody would really see it. I didn't
wow.
think it'd be the first thing that would come up when you Google my name.
I know, now it just comes up.
It really is a how do you say this? A terrific photo.
There had to be, but I mean, come on. There had to be shenanigans going on that day. Like, it's your first day doing stuff, and like, oh, what can we have her do? Oh, I know what we need.
Yeah,
let's put her in skin tight spandex.
No,
and mold her ass.
No one has ever brought up this myth before. Shut up.
In the pants.
Yeah. Jamie's like, oh, I know what we could do
yes.
today.
Yes, there's a myth that a man can hold his breath with an ass on his face.
You're naughty.
Jimmy
you
is
are naughty.
Bad. Isn't he bad?
But I'm just saying that's. You know,
Jimmy.
Sorry.
So then you got got a little more involved though as time went on.
Yeah.
Obviously, and it was kind of refreshing to see a little. I must say, Jamie and Adam, nice enough guys, but not as good to look at. I think they wanted to get somebody, and they got somebody that actually you know was able to do some of the.
Well,
some of
it wasn't like a
heavyweight.
Casting thing, though. It wasn't like we
it
were
just
looking for
happened,
people.
Right.
It was just, you know, we worked at the shop. I mean, all of those guys have worked together before at ILM. I mean, we're in San Francisco. Mm-hmm. We're not in an L.A. atmosphere where mm-hmm. there's tons of people throwing down resumes. We all just kind of worked there, and they were filming us. I mean, it's actual reality. It's not like we have writers like most reality shows. Mm-hmm. We're being followed by a camera, so we mess up. They're there.
And then all of a sudden, though, you start getting kind of noticed, I guess. You get recognized. And then being an intern for a silly little cable show turns into a big show. And you didn't have any real fame or notoriety before that, so
no.
Were you expecting that at all? Or
are you kidding me? I had no idea that this was going to be my career. In fact, I'm pretty sure my parents are psyched I have a job.
Really?
I was an art major, you know.
Do they still think it's like, oh, I can't wait till she gets a real job?
Oh no. They are so proud of me.
Yeah, my parents are silly like that. They're like, oh, God, he does his little show with his friends. I'm like, no, it's a real job, I swear.
Hey, how was Obama? Was he on set?
No, actually, Jamie and Adam went to the White House, and they did a little thing, and he just issued a challenge for us. He didn't actually participate in the rest of the myth. We used his contacts.
Try to keep your tax money? Is that the challenge? Sorry, not a fan.
So wait, did
the myth is I'm going to be able to keep more than half my income. Oops! Oh, no. Busted.
Did they get to meet him?
Oh, yeah.
Why didn't you go? Were you kind of annoyed when they're like, look, you're going to have to sit this one out?
No, actually, I was working on something really cool back in San Francisco.
You blow that off to meet the president.
What's cooler than going to the White House and hanging out with Obama?
Well, I mean, that's pretty cool, but I mean, it was pretty cool to also
building something explodes or rocket powered.
Or something very heavy and car crushing that might be happening. I mean, we're the episode. We have another myth that we're doing at the same time, and Jamie and Adam are working on that one. And Obama basically just gave us 500 school kids. He gave us the contacts to get 500
really?
Kids to help them out. I mean, that was amazing.
Oh, okay. I wonder what they're doing.
Oh, well, that's pretty public. He wanted us to retest the solar.
Oh, the solar the ships.
Yeah,
right.
The Archimedes death ray.
He believes it, right?
I wouldn't say he believes it. He just didn't like our methodology of how we tested it.
Well, maybe you didn't like his policy on healthcare.
If I ask, would it ruin the episode to ask what about the myth being busted your way? Did he not agree with?
He thought we didn't have enough manpower. He wanted to see actually what it would happen.
Just take the 10% of the country that's unemployed. Sorry, I'm not a fan.
Okay, I'm getting this. Yes.
Got that a while ago.
Well, what I really love about this is we're working with the STEM program, which is the Science, Technology, Engineering, Mathematics, which kids are not getting into science anymore, so it's really nice to see a big push to try to get kids into science, because we're, you know, the pipeline for scientists and engineers is drying up in America, and we need some homegrown cures for cancer, for solutions for pollution.
But do you think that kids are getting more into science these days as opposed to maybe 10 years ago because of the popularity of channels like Discovery and the Science Channel and History and shows like Mythbusters and things like that?
I'm going to say yes.
Yeah. Yes. Exactly.
Exactly. I have a big impact on the world.
Changing the face of the nation.
Look, you know, I was a terrible student, and I certainly wasn't interested in science. I mean, I like science. I wasn't interested in it up until, I mean, you put on Discovery Channel 24 hours a day.
I know.
I wasn't interested in science until I heard you were in D.C. and I had to get a telescope.
Rose is just mad because he got bumped out off the big boy table.
I don't like it. I'm back here fucking dog.
Have your macaroni and cheese back there.
We made him get out of the big boy seat.
You're in his table.
Danny made me move.
I feel bad.
This is how I know Danny's nervous, because I've interviewed people that I was very nervous interviewing, but I know Danny's he's never like this. Is that he's asking questions and they're not moving. So, do you think science was always popular? And then he just stops.
I knew he was nervous when he said shenanigans.
Yeah. Pardon my French.
Not at all. I like the shenanigans. You do a show also called Head Rush.
Yeah, that's focused at the kids.
And that's focused it's kind of like Mythbusters, but geared more toward teens and stuff.
Sure. It's commercial free. Yeah, it's Mythbusters, but commercial free. And instead of commercials, I do experiments.
You get
sort of like Bill Nye the Science Guy, kind of little small experiments.
A little different than Bill Nye.
You don't have to explain it to me.
Thank you. A little different than Bill Nye.
A DVR Head Rush every day at 4 p.m. on the Science Channel.
I don't tune in Bill Nye to just look at Bill Nye.
Bill Nye is awesome.
I know, but you're awesomer.
Well, I'll take that as a compliment, because I definitely respect the guy.
Yeah. Was he a role model?
It's like Mr. Wizard.
Yeah, was Mr. Wizard a role model?
Man, I met Bill Nye at a party, and actually, he's a fun guy to talk
really?
To.
Really? Yeah. At a party?
Yeah.
Just drinking out of a beaker?
Oh, is that Mr. Wizard?
Fun.
Who's Bill Nye? I don't know the name.
Bill Nye, the science guy.
What's wrong with you, Jimmy?
I don't know the name.
Jimmy.
I don't know who the Mythbusters are. I just don't know who Bill Nye is.
You've never watched an episode of MythBusters?
Yes, I have.
I'm turning you in right now.
They did a great one about pulling a fucking phone, two phone books apart.
Oh yeah, yeah, phone
books.
It was
amazing.
Wait, you can swear here?
Yeah.
We're on serious, huh?
Satellite radio.
Yeah. Like, what do you want to say?
The best.
So that's your... why you can be on the radio.
Yes, I'm very dirty. I don't curse that much, though.
I actually...
He's behaving, actually.
I'm a fan of yours.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
I know you're naughty, so...
Thank you very much.
But you've seen him before?
Well, you know, I saw you on the Louis show. And
God damn it.
Yeah, that, now I want to kill Jim.
Now, we hate when people come in here and know Jimmy.
Why not? Why?
We just don't like it.
Can't Karen and I just get along and have a couple people that kind of get to know each other? What's
Karen?
Wrong with that?
Shut up. Yeah. What'd you call it? Karen?
Karen.
Carrie.
Can't Karen and I get along?
So you saw the trailer for one of the shows where they put the phone book together with the pages, and now you've seen every episode?
No, Tanks had actually
I'm
took
so
to pull it apart.
I'm so trying to undermine this.
Oh, no, but Tanks just took to pull it apart. That was actually very interesting.
He knows.
Jimmy. Yuck.
He's watched. Are you a married woman?
Yes.
Yes, I'm married.
And a little baby.
Yeah.
You had to take a little leave of absence?
I did.
Did you miss the show?
You know, I was pretty happy to be home for 4 months.
It was a
nice vacation because I worked till I was 10 months pregnant, so I was at the bomb range when I was gigantic.
Bomb range. That's great.
Yeah, being pregnant at the bomb range is a hard thing to do. There's lots of hills going. There's no place to go to the bathroom. It's insane.
How do you guys, I know sometimes you've had insurance issues where they're like, oh, they won't allow us to do this. But then you're able to completely destroy and explode a cement mixer.
Well, yeah, but I mean, the things that insurance has a problem with are usually things that are going to cause us bodily harm. But we have so many experts with us. It's like the bomb range is the safest place to be. When we're doing stuff like that, we've got FBI, we've got the bomb techs, we've got all these experts keeping us safe. We're in bunkers.
But how did a little show to get to like do that? If you put together when they first started, a little show going like, hey, we want to blow something up. Let's call the FBI and get some dynamite. Like, it seems like it would be a very difficult thing to do.
Yeah, but think about what some of these guys do on a regular basis. And it's going to, they get to actually go out to the bomb range and blow things up for
and have fun.
Yeah, you know, they're not out giving tickets or anything.
I bet we wouldn't be able to do that, though. Oh, hi, God. We do a radio show and we'd like to blow something up. They'd be cuffing us.
Yeah, of course.
Investigating
Where do you guys go? How far is this from where you go? Like, I guess you have a giant open area you go to.
Yeah, it's a baseball field in Frisco.
So I'm curious as to how far it is. It's a very metropolitan area.
It's about, an hour from us. The Bay Area is awesome. We have everything we need. We have all these abandoned naval bases and all these open areas. And the city right in the middle has everything we need, like, you know, metal shops and wood shops.
It is amazing. It's like, oh, we need a house. Because you're doing the experiment with the bug. You take the bug spray stuff, bombs, and fill up a house with it. And it's like, oh, yeah, we need a house to explode.
But we have, like, this amazing team of really charming researchers that talk people into the most amazing things. Like, we got a 747 to play with.
Yeah.
I mean, who gets that?
Yeah, that was a good one, too.
Yeah.
What was the most shocking myth that was actually true that you thought was bullshit?
Well, it's actually not a big, crazy one. It's kind of a small one. We had this gag. We were doing red flag to a bull where we're trying to see if the red actually aggravated them. And so just as a gag, we're like, let's do bull in a china shop, you know? Like, it'll just be funny. We'll see a bunch of carnage. So we set up this china shop with a whole bunch of thrift store dishes and in like a small pin. It was probably like 15 by 15 and just let a bull loose. And we thought he would just smash everything. Such agility and grace, danced around all the shelves, didn't knock over one dish.
He straightened a Hummel.
That's great. We released 2, 3, 4, 5 bulls, didn't knock over a dish. We actually had more dishes knocked over in the thrift store by my co-host Tori when we were trying to buy the dishes than any of the bulls ever did.
Here's the video.
Oh, wow, look at this bull. He's actually shopping.
Yeah, I mean, that was pretty insane.
That is a good one.
Was that your favorite myth? What was your favorite myth?
Oh, man. Yeah. Demolition Derby by far.
Yeah, that was a good one. Yeah.
Yeah, I was in a Sikorsky helicopter dropping a car, trying to hit an X, and Grant was radio controlling a car from the other end of the desert, and we were trying to make the two cars meet at the middle. That was crazy.
You get to do fun
That's
things.
That's awesome, yeah.
I do.
You know, going back to that insurance thing, I was actually surprised that one of the last episodes, Cold Feet, with Tori, I mean, they put him in. The whole myth was to see if cold feet was something that you can get, like if you could be scared enough where your feet actually get colder than your core temperature. And they put Tori in a stunt plane and took him up and started doing some pretty sick shit and doing like three and a half G's. And as I'm seeing him get into this cockpit and go down the road, I'm like, they're not going to let him do this. Like, there's no way. Because I know that some of the stuff that they haven't been able to do in the past.
Yeah.
Sure enough, the guy took him up.
We gave him a parachute.
I was surprised about that.
We scared the heck out of him, though. You know, what you don't see on the show is I talk to the pilot. I'm like, can you freak him out a little bit? Can you maybe say some stuff? Can you, like, maybe make the plane stall just a little bit and be like... Really, get ready. We're going to have to jump. Could you do something? And so he definitely had a few extra thrills up there that you didn't see.
The pilot was showing him how to roll off of the wing in case he has to eject.
Oh, my God.
Was it a military jet or was it a plane? No. It was a stunt plane.
So how do you roll off the wing? What does that mean?
Well, like if you fall out.
They were playing with his head and trying to gas him up, but...
Well, yeah, because if you'd fall out of the plane, you're probably going to hit the tail, so they were showing you how to not just get, you know, hit by the tail, but to roll off of it, like G.I. Joe style.
Oh, wow. And did his feet get cold?
Not as cold as mine did. You know, we had some other tests. I don't know if you didn't see the show.
I'm a fan. I watch all the time.
We had to...
Danny, will you recite the episode blow by blow for us right now, please?
Well, it starts off with that blue paper and then a silver Sharpie.
Well, we were trying to test, you know, what would really scare us, so we all got to come up with what scared each other. I knew Tori was scared of heights, so we did the stunt plane. That's kind of like a thrill fear, and then Grant scared.
You just bring Grant outside. You just bring him into a city environment, and he got freaked out.
Oh, worse. He's scared of spiders. Are any of you scared of spiders?
No.
Not at all?
Unless they're on me. Like, if there's one here, I'm like, I don't like it, but I'm not telling
you. Okay, well, imagine tarantulas the size of your hand being dropped in your head while your head is sealed in a glass box.
No.
I've done other things in a glass box.
Naughty.
So wait. All right. So they put his head in. It's all.
We made a torture chair. We made him sit in a chair. He had to sit there. We put a box over his head, and there's a little hole in the top. And then I just start dropping tarantulas on him. Yeah.
Was he screaming? I mean.
Oh my. He looked like he was gonna wet his pants. He was so scared. Like he was going.
Do they bite? They don't bite, right? Were they?
I didn't get ones that bite. I'm not that cruel. I mean, I wanted to freak him out. I didn't want to kill him.
Scary.
I think the most scared I ever saw Grant was when you guys did that myth where you guys were in the water, and I think sharks were in the water as well, and one like brushed up against him, and apparently he does not like when fish touch him in the water.
Apparently, he claims this is a real phobia, that other people have this phobia, that fish touching you is.
Yeah, I pretty much don't like that.
I don't think
at all.
I like that.
Really?
It's about the unseen. Yeah. It's about the unseen, though. It's under the water. That doesn't go back to childhood at all. A hand on the knee.
If I was walking down the street and a fish touched my leg, I wouldn't care.
I have a friend with fear of Abe Vigoda. I have a friend with a fish phobia, and we went to the Museum of Natural History or Natural Science, whatever. And when you go into the room with all the fish replicas and shit like that, she has to cover her eyes in the room and scream and run through it.
That's fucking crazy.
Those are the people I like to torture. Yeah. It's like, that's so easy to mess with.
Can I hire you to put her head in a box and drop fish on her head?
That would be awesome.
To see what happens.
Yeah, you do have a torturous side of you.
It goes all around. I mean, I love using the taser on Tori when he's not expecting it. It's kind of like coffee for him.
Did you have a fear that you did? What was yours?
I did. Mine was more like a dread. It's kind of the gag on the show that they like to make me gag. They love to try to get me to throw up, and they feel like they've really accomplished something if they can get me to fruition, if I can actually puke. So,
through motion or what you see?
I'm a vegetarian.
Okay.
So they'll like send me to the butcher, and like the butcher will throw a tongue at me and be like, "Duh." They'll be like, "Here's some pig entrails. Could you put this in a blender? Because we need it for something." But in this particular case, they blindfolded me and brought me out into the shop, and the smell was so bad. I could hear them sort of dry heaving as they led me out. What are they doing to me? And then I sit down at this table. They take the blindfold off, and there's this sort of buffet of like chicken feet, fish head, pig entrails, like the nastiest stuff you've ever seen. And then they bring out this platter of like live bugs, maggots, hissing cockroaches, scorpions, crickets. And they said, pick two. You have to eat them.
Oh.
And I was just looking, it's like salmonella, trichinosis, dysentery, it looked really bad. The cleanest thing to me looked like the bugs, because they were lab grade. So I figured that would probably be the safest. So
sure.
Choked down a little maggot worm to start with, which actually was a good choice because it slithered down pretty easily, even though it really freaked me out. Second choice was a cricket, and that was a bad choice. They're really spiky.
Are they bitter?
Well, I was trying to just swallow without chewing.
Oh,
so
yeah, they got a lot of spines and stuff on them.
Yeah. You can hear them inside you.
It got stuck right here, and I was going, and it was live. It was stuck right there, and I'm torturing it by.
Come on, now.
I did throw up.
Oh, you did.
Well, it was stuck in my throat.
Good for them.
But then they made me eat it again because it was. I had to eat it.
Oh my God.
I know. I am a. I said this on the show. I'm a grown woman. Boys are still trying to make me eat bugs. I can't believe this.
You're a trooper.
I would have eaten the maggots too. You know they're disgusting.
Oh, look at those fucking way.
They're the cleanest.
Clean, I know, but look at that.
They clean wounds. They're good if you have a wound. That's why they put maggots in a wound. They clean the wound.
What year are you in?
I know.
Well, I'm just saying they could.
How about antibiotics? Yeah.
I like maggots.
You know, it's good for sickness, a nice bleeding.
I got some leeches in case you get a cut.
Yeah, that's rough, man.
Yeah, you look really unhappy there.
Oh, yeah. The smell around me was also just, it was making you want to throw up as it was.
You ever get scared with doing something? Though. Like, where you're like, oh, that's just too, like, scary?
You know, the shark special, we had to test whether sharks were afraid of flashlights. So we were put
You're
under...
You're afraid of flashlights?
We'll see. I'm afraid of being in completely dark water with sharks with the lights off.
I could see that.
Yeah. And then at one point that, you know, before we got our testing done, you know, we turned off all the lights because we had to do a control test to see how many sharks would show up in the area to start with. So you'd feel... Whoosh, whoosh. You didn't know if it was a turtle. You didn't know if it was a shark.
Man,
you didn't know
no
if it was
way.
A diver. And I was just like, okay.
No.
Just like, come on, buck up. I have to handle this. They're handling this. I'm handling this.
Yeah, you are in a boys' club over there, so it does seem like you have to kind of go one step beyond.
Now, just keep up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Is it different now that you're a mom? Is there some stuff that maybe you would not do now that you would have previously?
No. No.
Look, you're still gone.
No. You're a trooper.
Nice. No,
I love the fact it's like, nah.
No, I still jump. I still jump out of planes.
Yeah, there's the cricket stuck in your throat.
They have a puke cam.
They're so mean. That was really bad.
A puke cam. That's funny. God.
You know, it was kind of a semi-disturbing episode. It was from a while ago, but the water torture. You had a tough time with that.
I've got nightmares.
What is your water torture?
You were like really screwed up about that one.
Well, I mean.
What is it?
Okay,
they just did the Chinese
water torture where they drip water in your head. But we, you know, just for the looks of it, we made this like splinter-ridden table, and we used Civil War shackles to shackle us up so that we couldn't move, and we had to be tortured by the water.
They had to make it
Where's
hot.
Your forehead?
Yeah, it's on my
right
DVR.
Here on your forehead. It was drip, drip, drip. So like you couldn't like tune it out. Every time a drip would hit, it just brought you back into the fact that you're being tortured. I don't think we really thought this through as a myth because the best case scenario is torture.
Yeah,
how
torture.
Long? How do you not just move your head to the left or right? Or do they stay?
It was strapped down. I had
this couldn't move.
Yeah, it was strapped with like a leather strap and this thing that held my face there.
She
and
got so upset.
How long into
sad.
It do you start to get really bothered by it? Like after how many? Is it 10 minutes or is it an hour that's tolerable?
I was at about an hour. I started to freak out because I was getting claustrophobic and my arms started cramping. And but I didn't want to call it. I didn't want to look like a wimp. And so the EMT actually had to say, you know what, she's done. Because I started to cry a little bit.
I'll make it.
I'll make it.
Oh my
and they're
God.
Like, no, you're done.
But how long would the Chinese do that for? Like, what's
probably days.
Yeah, look, she's crying.
Look at her crying.
That's terrible. Were you taking mite all that time? Was it?
Can you see one finger I'm holding?
All right, Carrie just cut me off.
She's crying.
Just give me a second.
No,
okay?
I didn't.
No, of course not. I know, you're very wholesome.
I had a moment of sheer terror and panic.
That's the face we want you to have by the time you're done with this interview.
It's so strange. I didn't expect going into this that I was going to freak out and start crying in front of everybody. I mean, I knew I could get up at any time, but the restraints totally made me lose it.
Wow.
I actually haven't watched this episode.
Really?
Oh, you've never watched it?
Oh, no.
It's like a Hannibal Lecter mask almost. It's holding the face in place.
Wasn't the water like cold, I think?
The water we did on Tori was ice water, but it didn't make this episode. I guess they thought it was more fun to watch me cry.
watch ice water drip on Tori's
head.
And
it was high, too, right? It drips from high up. I didn't realize that.
Yeah, I actually kind of, the worst part is we were making this. I make torture devices for myself. Like, how messed up is that?
Yeah, that
it's
is
like,
pretty
go
sick.
Pick the switch off the tree kind of thing, you know?
How come he's not bolted in?
Oh, because we wanted to try it without being restrained. Because we couldn't go through with it, and we wanted to just kind of isolate the water torture. And we put him in a diaper so that he'd have to lay there for a long time. But I don't know if you knew this about adult diapers, but they're not like baby diapers where they're supposed to take a full thing of pee. It's for a little bit of drip. So like all of a sudden he's like he had to run because he's like, this isn't holding. Oh, I don't remember if that was in the episode or not, so maybe I shouldn't have said that.
How does that place ever get clean? Like, I was just watching that poo episode, and like, it wasn't real poo that they were using, but there was just shit flying all over the place, and I'm like, there's no way they're getting everything. Like, there has to be just rotting stuff from 5 seasons ago just hanging around that warehouse.
When I was an intern, my job was to scrape the chicken guts off the ceiling after they had rotted. And so nice now that I have interns.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, my God. Clean out the fridge is the worst.
That is a good,
clean out the fridge.
That's a good feeling.
We have two fridges now because I put a human skull in the fridge where everybody put their lunches.
Oh, that kind
and
of.
And I had made, like, fake brains and stuff in it. And, you know, the experiment went longer than we thought, and it started to rot in there. And apparently the smell was really bad. And the office was getting mad at me. They're just like, you can't put a human skull next to my sandwich. So we had to get two fridges, one for human food and one for the stuff that we leave out. And in particular, that banquet that they made me eat, we kind of stuck that in the fridge and then forgot about it over the weekend. And then we forgot about it over a period of a few weeks. And then somebody had unplugged the fridge for sound issues. And we're like, what is that smell? What is going on? And so somebody goes, oh, I think it's the fridge, opens the door. We had to evacuate the shop.
Wow, that bad.
Jeez. Yeah, it was like that scene from Stand By Me. Where he's like,
blah, it's great to know.
It'd be like cleaning the workshop in Saw.
Exactly.
It's great to know the same crap happens where you work. Like, you
what?
Watch Mythbusters.
What? You have human skulls in your fridge?
Well, not so much human skulls, but just, yeah, nasty garbage and.
I would like to play a game. We're going to see if shit is flammable.
Hey, what does your husband do? Is he kind of like alpha like you are, like test limits, or is he, you know, a corporate guy?
He is a tattoo artist by day, okay. And then on the weekends he races motorcycles.
Yeah, see, that's the man. Type of people that are attracted to
a man.
Both, yeah, they both yeah. kind of...
I have tattoos and a motorcycle.
Yes, he's laughing. Sure.
Well, I think that's illegal in America.
Yeah, but they're hemp and it's a moped.
Oh, Dan.
How long are you married?
I've been with him for a decade.
Okay.
I've only been married for about 5 years.
Was it weird for him, like, when you both kind of start seeing each other and you're just kind of both not in the limelight, then all of a sudden... his wife or girlfriend is now a celebrity. Is that, like, uncomfortable for him, or is he fine
at
with it?
At first, it sucked for him because, you know, I go out to places and boys were noticing me a little bit more, and sure. I'd get creepy emails, and then there'd be a picture Damn of us sorry. On the internet from going to an art show, and then all of a sudden there'd be all these comments like, who is she dating, her dad? Like, just really mean stuff.
And dear Carrie, you're going to be in D.C., right?
Yes. I have a hat and glasses as well as a tattoo and a motorcycle, just listing things.
He's used to it now. He's super cool with it. He doesn't worry about it anymore.
Is he older than you?
No, same age.
Oh, wow. Okay. They were just being dicks.
Real
jerks. Yeah. Oh, yeah. No, they were just being jerks.
Oh, wow.
I mean, it's the internet. You're 14. You're in your basement. You're angry. There's an outlet.
Exactly. I'm looking for you. Oh.
Most of our fans are really nice, and they'll actually kind of attack those people for me. I don't.
Yeah.
I never have to respond.
I bet you're very defended as far as
I've got a lot of
viewers go.
I think he actually is.
Danny.
Me a few times. Are you, you know...
Yes.
Oh,
Fanboy 44.
No.
He's RP1ST.
No, I don't do the message board thing.
Terrible.
Picking a creepy script.
Yeah, that is a creepy name.
I fear is he picked that so quickly, I swear. That's gotta be his handle. That's gotta be his handle.
Too. It was too fast. He had to have jotted that one down a few times.
Do they have chat rooms anymore? I think that, yeah.
Oh, yeah. But I haven't gone in a long time. They used to be fun, but then it's just like, I'm gonna get screen capped doing this.
Yeah. do you take criticism well or
uh-oh.
Yeah, I do now.
What are you
you get enough of it.
Yeah, you get enough of it, and it's like, you know,
I always noticed that,
like, you want to hunt them down and kill them.
But. On that show, they always reference the fact that, like, the fans thought we did it wrong. The fans think that blah blah. I mean, that must just happen all day long. Like, you have to, when you have to do a new myth because some fan said that you did it wrong, like, there has to be some part of you that just gets angry about that.
I actually kind of like it because, you know, usually it's a fun thing to go back and test differently, and it's a lot of interaction with the audience, and I feel like we have kind of a different show where we you know, really talk to our audience, and they help us with stuff, and they give us content, and if a bunch of people really want us to do it over,
I bet they're not worded like we would think they would be. I bet it's not like, you know, you're experimenting.
You fucked that up!
Think,
you suck! You didn't even use what you were supposed to. You suck. I'm never watching the show again.
We actually have a higher caliber of fan than that.
That's
it's usually
fans. Sorry,
more
yeah, we're just used to this
word. It's like the O&A.
O&A fan wording here. Yeah.
You suck. I hate you. You were so much better before they brought Carry On.
Hey, right, whatever.
Hey, douche fuck, come to Poughkeepsie and try to do that fucking myth. We're going to do duct tape again?
Exactly. That is one myth I'll do 1,000 times. I love duct tape.
That was fun.
What was the myth?
I thought it was stopping that car.
Duct tape can do anything. And one of the last myth we did that I really loved is that duct tape could put a car back together that was destroyed. So they gave me a car, and they said, destroy it. Use anything you want. So I had demo saws. I had torches. I had a Jaws of Life. I brought in the fire department to like pull the roof off, just demolish this car, cut hoses, stab the tire. And then my co-host Tori and Grant walked in, and I threw them some duct tape and was like, fix it. It was great. Little did I know they were going to make me drive it, because that was kind of dangerous.
Yeah, drive the duct-taped car,
But it fixed, right?
Yeah. I mean, it got put back together, and it drove for a while, and I may have driven a little too fast because my driving might have destroyed a little bit of it. Two wheels were off the ground at one point. I'm not going to say anything more.
How long have you guys been on the air?
7 years.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
okay.
That is wild. Wow. Yeah.
I feel like I've grown up on the show.
Yeah, kind of have. We've all watched you grow up.
And how long was the show on before you actually became on air?
I think about a year I was behind the scenes.
Oh, so you've been on for that long?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, okay. Because that's got to be nerve-wracking. A show is popular, then you come on, like, what if I screw up, or what if people don't like me, and what if the show fails?
Yeah, because the show was really gaining popularity, and then they brought, like,
that's
even
they had
though
to
you
bring
guys are behind the scenes. Yeah, yeah. I guess to do some of the, because initially it was just to do some of the busy work. You know, hey, build this. We don't have time. We're
it
doing
just
this.
Didn't make things faster, so they're like, okay, you guys got to be hosts, because we got to crank these shows out. And, you know, we were actually staying with the science, so if something took 3 days to test, we'd spend 3 days doing
three days.
You know?
Yeah.
Or most
there.
Of our myths take at least 2 weeks. We have a regular job that's like 8 to 6 every single day and sometimes more, so it's pretty intense.
Ew.
It's not like a regular show where you just kind of show up and you film something. It's like, no, we actually do all the work. We're doing the welding. We're doing
And then there's the filming of the show part. Yeah, but before that, I guess all the welding and watching the science and making sure you did things right.
Yeah.
And that place is still a business, too. I mean, that's Jamie's place, right? So
we've got two shops now. Jamie's got his business at M5, and then we've got a second shop that my team works out of.
What was, like, the coolest stuff that each of them, Adam and Jamie, worked on as far as movies go in the past?
Star Wars?
Star Wars, right?
Yeah, Grant, too, I think, right?
Grant. They all worked on Star Wars.
Which one?
How cool is that?
The boys are Grant and Tori, they're quite young, so there's no way they're going to work on the first one. They saw the first one when they were little kids, so they grew up and, you know, somebody came to Grant and said, hey, would you like to drive R2-D2? And
really?
Holy shit. He must have wet his pants because he's a big fan.
Couldn't be.
I'm wetting my pants right now.
Why, you like Star Wars?
I love it so much.
Jesus,
Joel.
You don't
like anything, Jimmy.
I like Star Wars.
No.
I think it was a good movie.
Okay,
oh, well, what? Why are you going to trash me?
I'm not going to trash you.
Okay.
George Lucas.
Because you're a fanboy, man.
Because they started to...
Oh, unlike what's happening in the room right now? I'm the fanboy that's out of line. I'm like a fucking movie.
but I'm saying because the Ewoks...
No, look, there are elements of... There are
the
elements
in the third one. It's all about marketing toys to children after a while. It's starting to suck.
There are elements of Star Wars that I don't care for. But for your advice, the only reason they were Ewoks was because it was supposed to be a planet of Wookiees, but they used the Wookiee with Chewbacca in the first film, so he goes, well, let's just make them little Wookiees then.
Exactly, another toy that we can market that's cute. That's great space drama. It stinks.
Well, it's simplifying the movie for you, Joe.
Jim's Ewok impression is the same noise you make for sucking cock in your act.
Oh, Jesus!
Just messed up the whole interview.
Was it too much?
She just covered her mouth and everything.
I'm sorry.
Watch your language. Carrie's out there. It's not,
I would like to remind you that I host a kid's show.
Yes. She hosts a kid's show.
He's not here every day, so don't pay attention to him.
He's
some fucking local comedian that needs a gig plus.
This is his last appearance on this show.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God.
The minute I walk out of the room, I know this is going to go
bad. Thanks a lot, Joe. Thanks a lot.
I'd rather bring back Mercurio.
Yeah.
He's the guy that got us fired.
Oh, my.
And we'd rather have him.
You know, I did like,
get it?
I did like in the original Star Wars, though. I thought the Cantina band scene was very realistic.
Oh, now that was...
Boo!
What?
Ooh, that's terrible.
Oh, my. Do you realize there's probably just, like, a bunch of nerds out front right now that are in costume that are just, like... calling for your head.
They would agree with me. They know it stinks. That stupid elephant. Terrible. Terrible. Lucas and his weak chin. Terrible.
I don't know if that's really an adversary you'd like to go up against.
I liked the movie. I thought it was a really good movie. But those elements of it made me hate him. Because like there were such great movies, and then they throw in like...
This took the realism, though, of space. It took it out of, like, the hands of just these technical astronaut people to people that went to bars and hung out and they had to make it alien. What were we supposed to do? Put the pips up there?
I didn't think the puppets were very good.
When this came out, it was pretty revolutionary. I mean, looking at it by today's standards is totally different. But looking at it back then, it was crazy.
Look, he's got an Ozzy Osbourne shirt on. It tells you what time he comes from.
Exactly, the same time that came out. Yeah, they mapped his DNA. I actually want to have my DNA mapped. I'm hoping I'm related to him somehow. Great would that be for me and not him.
Hey, Joe, you want to defend the movies now?
Huh?
You want to defend
them? I was just going to say
or that scene?
You can't trash Star Wars but also own the new Ozzy Osbourne record.
Sure, I don't think that's
fair.
Why not?
I don't think it's fair.
Why? At least it's adult stuff. It's not childish.
Come on.
You got to admit that's catchy. You still know the tune.
It is true, but you know, I remember a lot of things from childhood that weren't good. This is one of them.
Would you prefer that they'd be playing Ozzy?
Yay.
Yeah. What you do is you mute the movie, you put on your own soundtrack, and you watch it again.
Put some Ozzy in the background.
Yeah, right?
I love
Hans trying to make a deal for a ship, and
come on,
Ozzy playing.
I'm playing War Pigs in the bar for you, Jimmy.
Darth Vader's one of the greatest bad guys ever. Ever. One of the greatest villains ever. The whole movie was
the greatest.
Maybe, yeah. I mean, I would probably take Dracula over him, but I mean, I do like Darth Vader.
Stop. Dracula would be silly in space.
Yeah, that's true.
Bro, he'd float away.
Nobody's scared. He's the best voice, too. He's the best voice.
He does, yes.
Who, Dracula or Darth Vader?
Yes. Darth Vader.
James Earl Jones.
Yes. I mean, it's amazing.
This is CNN. Same guy.
Is that him?
Yeah,
I didn't know that.
David
Prowse, the body of Darth Vader, we've talked many times. Did you ever see Clockwork Orange?
Yes.
The big bodybuilder that carries him down the steps in the wheelchair? That's Darth Vader.
That's the guy that was in the
costume. I didn't know that.
Yes, that's Darth Vader. That's
the guy in the
British bodybuilder.
Hey, we got a lot of fans checking in. I just want to take one from Bill and Philly.
I don't want to talk to
the
fans right now.
Hello, Bill. Not you.
Hello, fellas. Opie, follow me. Carrie.
No.
Yeah.
I'm afraid to ask this after what Danny just did, but have you ever considered redoing the baseball miss?
Oh, which one?
What you guys did was you're seeing if it's faster sliding or running,
mm-hmm.
and you did it in the second base.
Mm-hmm.
The real miss is if it's faster to slide or run through first base.
Well, I will bring that back and suggest it to him. That's kind of what we do. So
The difference is you can overrun first base. You can't overrun second or third.
Right.
So that's why it's probably faster.
You're going to be slowing down going into it. First, you just keep on running.
Right. So I would say the sliding is slower, but it's a necessity so you don't run into left field.
I've seen people do it I don't know if it's faster, but I've seen people do it to evade a tag.
Sliding into first is slower.
Do it in baseball, the announcers say, oh, well, it's slower to slide, but players still do it.
I say that a lot, actually, on dates.
So what happened?
I'll just talk to a girl about sliding into first. And she spits on me.
Danny.
What's that?
Danny?
Yes, sir.
Jimmy is doing better than you, Harry.
What are you gonna do? Well, and Ant's trying real hard too.
So,
Danny, you're really out.
Danny's asking
so out.
Very.
I know she's a lovely girl.
You're kind of
cockblocking
Danny a little bit.
She's beautiful, but I appreciate.
I'm being very.
Let Danny ask
a
question.
Any
Danny, it's your turn.
I'm being very childish. Danny's asking good questions.
Let me see.
You go ahead.
Can I?
You ever cheat?
Can I have something from your purse, from your personal belongings? No.
Yeah.
Couple of your fingers.
I might have a bottle of Purell you can have.
I'll have it.
Oh, there you go.
Just let me use some of it before I leave.
After she uses it, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, but then it'll be worth more to him if you use it before you give it to him. So that makes
those
sense.
Those are great boots, by the way. She has on the sexiest boots. They're like leg high, like middle of the higher than the knee boots.
Yeah, describe them. We didn't see them when she came in. Yeah.
You didn't, but a lot of people out there listening
screw
didn't.
Screw the audience.
I'm trying to let
the radio land.
I'm a big fan of leather boots. I love the lace-up ones that go up to your knees. Oh. They protect you. They're the best.
So I guess you're a vegetarian for health reasons, not for this kind of, no animals.
I just, I just don't like it.
Were you, for your whole life, you were a vegetarian?
Since I was 15, and it's sort of like if I go back now, I'll be sick.
Yeah, you probably would be sick. I know.
Are you hardcore, though?
What do you mean by hardcore?
I don't know. What's the difference? Is
Totally vegan where there's no animal products?
Yeah, I'm from San Francisco, so there's so many variations. Yeah. Like there's pescatarian, all that kind of stuff. So no, I eat cheese.
Pretty basic.
Yeah.
Okay, that's good.
My husband's from the south, so we have to have some
pain in the ass.
We're all forgetting.
You can't find a friggin' restaurant to eat in.
There's something to eat at every single restaurant
in San Francisco, maybe.
No, everywhere.
Yeah.
Everybody makes pasta.
My girlfriend used to get so mad at me when I would open the menu, and the first thing I would do is go, hey, they have this. Like, I'd point out stuff that she could eat.
Yeah.
And it's like, I can read the menu. Exactly. And it's like, well, I don't want to pick out what I want and then find out you can't eat here and then have to leave. Because then I'll be like, no, I want that.
And I feel your pain. It's tough to find a good restaurant in Manhattan.
No, Joe, there's plenty of good
ones. Oh, good old Jim.
I actually, it might just be laziness, but I kind of like having less options because you know what you want right away, and I kind of like getting
can you
food.
Eat the same thing like day after day sometimes?
Sometimes I do. I eat Cliff Bars just all
they're
the time.
Great.
I don't have a lot of time, it
Cliff
seems,
bars
so I just
rule.
I live on
peanut
those
butter.
Things.
Yeah, what's the, how
cheese.
Many hours a day are you actually working?
And the apricot one?
I work usually 8 to 6 on MythBusters, but then
8 to 6?
Yeah.
About
that's
that. A long
Carrie, can I ask
day.
You a question? We were supposed to bring
day.
Up over here, the one that's not talking much. we have a hockey question that maybe you guys want to take on. You know how guys are
Well,
the hockey fights.
Yeah.
I'm convinced that they don't punch as hard because they can't get traction.
Every action,
I don't know
lines,
if it's
a reaction.
I don't know
less friction on a skate.
I don't know if it's enough to do a whole thing on it, but as a scientist type person, what do you think?
I think that would be a great one to test. I don't. I you know.
I would think the force of the punch is not going to be as hard because you're actually you have less friction between your foot and the ground, and then a blade
back.
And ice. And
I think
you're
slide
back.
Slightly at least.
Yeah, but
I
can't
mean,
they come to a complete stop?
I'm, yes,
I'm,
they
you
can.
Know, there's not a lot of ice where I am. I don't know a lot about hockey, but can't they really grip into the ice with those
I
skates?
Think
like they're not.
Time,
right?
But
well, that's why you
got to
do it a couple different ways.
Yeah, so I'm thinking that it just depends on the guy and it depends on his skill.
You can thank me later, but there you go. There's an episode.
I'll put that in the Sportsmith bin and we'll try that later.
Sportsmith bin.
It'll never see the light of day. There's probably a million of those.
How much dumb ideas is Carrie?
Right.
I have a lot of them on the board, and I swear there's a lot of Sportsmith in every. We do themes. Well, you know, quite often they're kind of more of our audience themes, like ninjas or pirates. But we definitely do sports ones as well.
What's the best Sportsmith MythBusters did, Danny or Carrie?
Well, let's ask you. You probably watched it more than I did.
The best Sportsmith.
Yeah, I'm thinking now. I mean,
well,
I got like 7 years to
baseball myths. We did whether it's if you can hit a home run easier in humid climate because you have humid balls.
I remember one
curveball.
Whether or not it was possible to actually smack the leather off of a baseball by hitting it hard.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Come on. That's silly.
Was it?
Why?
You can, right?
Well, how hard do
well,
you
Well, you'd have
it?
You technically yeah, but I think
you need it like
the pitch would have to be coming in at like 200 miles an hour or something. There was a whole bunch of callus involved that it was just beyond what a human person
which
could,
is what
could
makes MythBusters
do.
Really good too. It's not like it's just like okay, that didn't work, let's move on. It's like okay, let's see what it would take to make that happen.
Yeah, that's a fun
whether
part.
It takes
it's
more
not
dynamite
about the myth.
Or it takes hitting something at 200 miles an hour instead of 60.
Or Robert Redford. That's all it takes.
Robert Redford.
That's all it takes.
Yeah, he never knocked the cover off. That was from the Sandlot.
No, the Natural. Doesn't he knock the leather off the ball in the Natural?
No, he hit the lights and broke the lights. Why don't you shut up, Joe DeRosa?
You're your stupid Star Wars knowledge.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Stop talking about men you find dreamy.
We really don't like Joe at all.
Dreamy.
Oh, guys. It's
right. Yeah, how about that hunk who directed Ordinary People?
Him. I have a question.
Yeah. Oh,
will there ever be any Mythbusters episode pertaining to 9/11 myths?
You know, conspiracy myths come in a lot. I find that one a little touchy.
Yeah, well, I can see how it could be, but...
Why don't you just leave that to me?
Yeah, well, believe me, there's people like that say, oh, that's why they don't do it, because, you know, it would prove the truthers.
Oh, you know what? Why don't they should do something about
that? Yeah, that would be a huge episode.
About the steel and the... Because people do respect those guys, and they're pretty thorough.
Never changing anyone's mind on that.
I know
that's the one thing about conspiracy. Yeah, like, no matter what you show them,
it's the agenda. It's not the truth, right?
And it's not as fun. You know, it's like based in a horrid tragedy.
It is still an interesting thing, though.
Most of our myths are.
Yeah. What if you're getting sucked through a plane by your anus is?
I don't think I saw that.
Didn't that they tested on the
Well, they did shoot through a pressurized cabin.
Yeah, really. They made a man of meat. And put him down in one of those old school diving suits.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
And then, like, you know,
hose.
And then cut the hose. And, like, you know, he just basically, you know, from the pressure, just kind of got sucked out. Like, Squaw was out of the suit. It was disgusting.
Yeah,
what happened?
So, some sick stuff.
The pressure was cut out.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, so
let
you know that
you.
That's based in.
Yeah, I'll tell you.
He probably watched it more.
She wasn't around for that one. That was when she was on maternity.
I bet you Danny knows more about Mythbusters than Carrie.
Oh, yeah.
We should do a little quiz real fast.
I guarantee it. I don't even want to do a quiz because some of those things, like, think about it.
Can we do
I did it 7 years ago, and he probably watched the episode
watched
five
it.
Times. Oh. I just did it.
And
five.
They
what were you doing 7 years ago on a Monday in January? You know, like, that's...
I was watching you on television.
Yeah. Hey, by the way, Joe was right.
About what?
I hate to say it. About the ball thing.
Yeah, it happens.
It was the beginning
natural.
Of the movie, supposedly.
Oh, who cares? I never watched it.
Exactly.
But we beat the shit out of you for no reason.
I know, for no
reason. And you took it and just
I wanted you to
was really
yourself.
Quiet.
What a surprise that I got tossed under the bus.
For something that was true.
Yeah, right. So how has the internet changed your job? Because it seems like you can check facts right away. Is it totally different than when
it
you started?
It made us seem a lot smarter than we are because people ask questions and you could just punch it up.
We could Google.
And then there's things like this, like video conferencing things.
Yeah.
Are you video conferencing while you're talking to me?
Yeah, yeah, like people, well, I'm not. Not when I'm talking to you, but some guests, I never even look them in the face. I just sit here and type how bad the guest was.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
None of the guests that are listening, it wasn't you.
I'm going to have to check with my fans what you're doing right now.
Oh, believe me, there's not you could check everything. There's not a peep on here. Usually, though, I'm like, oh, my God, can we please wrap this up? This guest sucks. God, yeah, no, his name's DeRosa.
what did I do? That I'm getting this shellacking all of
You're
a sudden.
You're not a cute redhead.
Exactly. And we don't
what
like
you
your
do?
Slacks.
You were born.
Your slacks?
God, they're... Oh, God,
Joe.
Damn it. I don't like it back on the couch.
No, the couch is a bad
Joe,
place.
Could you stand up and show her that you have no shoulders? They might be able to do a myth on that.
Do a myth on that.
They might be able to do a myth on that.
Can a man actually live without shoulders?
Could you ask a man who will never be general?
I say it's plausible.
Could you actually put shoulder pads on a guy that doesn't have shoulders? Could you show her at least, Joe,
I'm
please?
I'm feeling bad for him.
Look, no,
you can see
guy.
Just
turn around. You'll never see us again in your life. Look at these. What no shoulders.
I, what did I do?
Yes.
What did I do?
You were born.
Oh, my God. It's getting fucking... It feels really bad back here right now.
They haven't brought out the little paper
I feel like,
hat yet.
Yeah, the dunce cap for him.
I feel like the dog you throw fireworks
Joe.
At while it's tied to the tree.
Joe,
it can't do anything.
That's
what you did was you attacked
that?
Our guest.
No. I did not
so
attack
now we're attacking
the guest.
You.
Yes, you did. We didn't like
did.
It.
We didn't like it
at
all.
We just didn't like
we
it.
We don't like
we didn't
it.
Like it. She put her hand over her mouth. She was shocked by you.
Yes. By your language.
So yeah,
now,
you're
we,
bad
now
language.
We beat you up.
I'm very dirty and I've used appropriate
and
language.
You still haven't apologized to her for your potty mouth.
Had I been told that we weren't allowed
oh,
to say such things.
Excuse before the apologies,
girl. That always works. That always works.
Maybe you could feel it out with a certain guest and know and use common sense that, you know,
and by
have...
the way, I was making fun of Jim. I wasn't making fun of the guests.
Good
she
apology.
Said, oh, my.
Good apology.
Yeah, so far, very, very contrived.
I accept.
She's so
thank
uncomfortable.
You. Thank you.
What are you doing, like, touring around the country, just kind of pushing the show and everything?
No,
or
actually,
are you in New York for a reason?
I just happen to be in Washington, D.C. for the Science and Engineering Festival. So I was real close to New York, and I had a few days before I go do the math teachers conference. Conference in New Orleans. Oh. So I thought, hey, let's come check this place out. And you guys called, cool. So I'm here. I'm not pushing anything.
Oh, great. That's really cool. I like the fact that you just pop in and like that. Were you in New York a lot? No, not enough.
Danny? I love New York.
Yeah?
Danny was in New York.
There's so many cool... Are you here with your husband, I guess, right?
No.
You want to go to dinner?
Watch it.
There's a great place that I know. It's fantastic. Actually, in the meatpacking district, I know a cop down there. It doesn't matter. It's a meatpacking district.
They pack vegetables,
it doesn't mean they pack
too.
Meat or anything like that.
Isn't that the hip place?
It is, yeah. Sure. It's the place to be.
Used to be,
it's
not the place anymore. To be.
But I know a lot of people down there, and I know a law enforcement officer that takes care of everything and can get in anywhere.
He's a scumbag. Jeez. Don't go to dinner with him.
I think I'm actually going to dinner tonight with the guys from Popular Mechanics.
Anthony has Popular Mechanics at his
I know, at my house.
At his house. On his toilet.
I love it. It's great. It's great toilet reading.
Or airplane.
Or the airplane toilet. If you want to see if.
Who reads in the airplane toilet? That's disgusting.
Yeah, I know. I would never. I don't even like going in there.
I like to annoy the other passengers and bring the Sunday Times in.
They know it's going to be a while.
If I saw you heading there, I would hold up. Oh, they know
it's going
to land.
It's going to be a Lulu.
That's terrible. Oh, the guys from Popular Mechanics.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
Isn't that nice?
Just talk about popular things and mechanical things.
Jesus.
No, Popular Mechanics. Actually, there's two mechanics that she knows. They have a lot of friends.
She's going out to dinner with Jesse James.
They have a lot of friends, yes.
All right.
Popular.
I apologize for saying the C word
while
Anthony insults all your friends and tries to convince you to commit adultery right now. Sorry, I was out of line.
I just would have went on a nice dinner and that, and then good night.
Exactly.
Would have been anything. I think we have a lot in common as far as our interests go, things like that. As far as like what I can see here and what I've seen on television.
No reason to attack Joe, though.
I don't have to attack
There's
Joe.
No reason
wearing
to attack
matching
you.
Socks and shirt. They get anything wrong with that.
That's what you're supposed to do.
When you're in San Francisco, I'll be there in like March. So if you want to come to the show, you can probably come to the show.
I'll take you out to dinner.
Thank you.
I can take you places where they have steak.
That would be nice.
Oh. Yeah.
There you go.
She's going to take you out to dinner.
I'm a very good dinner companion.
So you're not. I
have excellent table manners.
Nice.
You know who got it? Tori has an inn at every restaurant.
Oh, good.
Yeah. He's Italian and everybody's his cousin.
Yeah, go with him, Jimmy.
So he can take us anywhere in town.
You ever been to Massapequa?
Yeah.
That's some great diners. Yeah.
Long Island.
Exactly. Yeah. Or maybe you can go where Ron Kovacs is making burgers with a hole in them. That's a callback from that movie. Okay.
I don't know what you're talking about.
It was Born on the 4th of July.
Oh.
Tom Cruise's best movie, I think.
No.
Best performance.
It was a pretty good movie.
Yeah, when was he better than Tom Cruise? He should have won the Oscar for that.
I agree.
Tropic Thunder. That's his best role.
Hey, you know
you can't just be fond of Top Gun, though, because that's, I mean.
Nah, but it's like, I watched that for other reasons.
Top Gun?
Yeah.
What other reasons?
Yeah, you like the volleyball scene.
Val Kilmer's
I
teeth.
I all three of us just headbutted him.
I know.
Now, really watching did. Goose get his head smashed, I always put a little LOL at that. Hated Goose. He would never take his shirt off.
Oh, God.
Despise
really
Goose.
At the volleyball
game. What was wrong with his chest that he didn't take his shirt off with the rest of the guys?
Sunken. His chest looked like Sean Stevenson's.
Yeah. Hey, that's a good reference right there.
Why don't we wrap up and get the hell home?
Our entire show, yeah.
See, we don't work as late as you do.
I know. This is kind of awesome. I think I want your gig.
It rules.
It is a good gig.
Yeah.
Go home.
We need interns.
Take a nap.
We sure do need interns.
I'm done with interning. I'll tell you what.
Sure do need interns.
I saw your intern out there. He looked browbeaten. The poor guy. He was just shy. He looked like you guys have been yelling at him.
Oh, no. That's our boss.
Yeah. Yeah. Yes. Was he bungling?
Yeah. Yeah, that'll happen.
Well, thank you guys so much for letting me come in.
Thank you for coming in. What are you kidding?
It's MythBusters Wednesdays at 9 p.m. on the Discovery Channel.
And Head Rush.
Every day.
Science Channel at 4 p.m.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Where you can see commercials for Dr. Michio Kaku.
All day long, nonstop. Yes. I will tell you about time.
I want to keep the show going because I want to see you get a picture and an autograph, Danny.
We could save that for later.
No, I want to do the play-by-play. So technically, the show's over, Carrie, so thank you.
Don't tell me I struck out. I knew she wasn't going out with me.
No,
I hate these people.
And I saw what she did with me. She's very nice. And she goes, hey, we'll go to dinner. He can take us out. She was letting me know, like, hey, you're a nice guy.
She's a married woman, for God's sake. You think she's going to go out with other guys?
No, but I mean, she was letting me know. Hey, look, you know, don't get your hopes up.
Exactly.
It could be a group of us.
Exactly.
That's fine.
Is it going to be a group?
I'm in a relationship.
Take Jimmy out to dinner?
Absolutely.
But if there's ever a rift in the marriage...
Take my number.
Now he's getting on an airplane. He's going to kick your butt.
Yeah, I wouldn't doubt it.
I'm in a very loving relationship.
Yes. What? Yes. That two guy.
That was
motorcycle.
A horrible face.
I don't want to deal with that.
Jimmy's face was
I don't have
horrible.
Any tattoos, and I'd fall over sideways on a motorcycle. I'm a wuss.
But he loves guns.
Yeah.
I do like my shooting.
He doesn't tell us how many anymore, but it's a lot.
I don't hunt because I don't like killing things. Yeah. But I like going to the range and shooting,
Yeah, all the times I'm shooting guns, there's cops there that are letting me use the guns. I don't actually go out and use them on animals or anything.
Yeah, take that. No, I feel bad, like, if kill an animal or something like that. But shooting targets at, like, range, it's great. It's a lot of fun. It's challenging.
Could you sign Danny's stuff while we...
I would love to.
Well, hang on.
What do you got,
Wait, let me
Danny?
Turn these
I'm
going to turn the TVs off.
Look at this.
Oh, see, that's me.
That's the guy who wants you to go out to dinner with him.
Karaoke with...
Her eyes got really big there, Ant.
I'm doing karaoke with a Barrett 50 caliber.
Yeah. The size of those bullets, they're like...
They're crazy shells, yeah. They're like $5 a piece.
Is that
Which is really fun when they're getting supplied to you.
Yeah, here.
I spent, when I was shooting the Dylan minigun, they were supplying the bullets. I went through like $20,000 worth of bullets.
Wow. It is insane. It that gun is crazy. Thank you.
Yeah, well.
I was having
that's what you
fun.
Get.
Oh, come on. I was just
This is crazy
fun.
Gun karaoke.
I was doing a character.
It's
crazy
on YouTube.
Crazy gun karaoke guy.
He's playing Anthony from the Opie and Anthony show.
I'm singing a peace song, too. Come on.
I like the effect on the voice.
Yeah, a lot of reverb cures a world of ills.
Yeah. I got worse on the internet.
Ah, see? Good. It's the internet. It's going to be there forever. I'm proud of everything that's on there.
That's what happens when you live alone and have a lot of money.
Yeah, someday you'll know that.
I got the alone part down.
Jesus.
Only one more step.
3, 2.